I couldn't remember what else. I've said some of the last couple days. Like, you jerk.
It's time for Garden City High School Buffaloes football on 99.9 The Rock. Buffaloes football brought to you by the agency Arizate Auto Repair, American Family Insurance agent Sonia Castillo, Dr. Jake Jewell's DDS, M&M Grain Bin, Accident Recovery Team, American Implement, Ashman Packing, Heinz Barbecue, Commerce Bank, Western State Bank, Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant, Maria Furniture, Moff Motors, United Wireless, Provincial Insurance Agent Greg Calcinetti, Lewis Automotive Group, Austin Pools and Spas, American Family Insurance Agent Chris Boyes, Burtis Motors, Crazy House, Tacos El Viejo, Fruta Delights, and Hydro Resources. Now it's Buffaloes football with the voice of the Buffaloes, Cal Friedman.
Happy Friday, Buffaloes fans, and welcome to Lewis Field here in Hayes as the North City Buffaloes are ready for their conference opener in the 2023 season. It's a battle of two 2-1 squads as Garden City visits the Hayes High School Indians. And with that, we welcome you into the American Indian pregame show. The pregame show is brought to you by American Indian, your John Deere dealer serving all of Western Kansas. For over 50 years, American Indian has been helping producers stay equipped with all their farming and ranching needs. Cal Friedman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. The second road trip of the season for this Buffaloes team, who's coming off a pair of wins and a whole lot of growing in their first two home games of the season. Let's rewind previews to Garden City's first road game of the season, which took place in late August as they took on Wichita Heights. This game, the Garden City jumped off to a great start in, leading 19-6 at the half, only giving up one first down on the defensive side of the ball. But it's a game that completely flipped in the second half as the Buffaloes were shut out and the Falcons were able to come from behind. Winning 20-19. Head coach Brian Hill says this team's been lacking that killer instinct to finish off games. Well, they came out and dominated in their last two home games against Wichita North and Wichita West, beating the Redhawks in week two by a final score of 17-15 and beating the Pioneers last week 35-6. But even still with that, Coach Brian Hill said that there still wasn't that killer instinct that he was looking for. In last week's game against the Pioneers, the Buffaloes were outscored in the third quarter despite getting off to an unbelievable first half start, leading it by four scores. It's something that Coach Hill has been trying to stress this week and improve in practice as the Buffaloes go into whack play. Something the Garden City did very well in last year, the Buffaloes taking on this A-seed, which is a very weird history. When I talked to Gotillo about it earlier this week, you'll hear it later on. American Implant Pregame Show, pregame interview brought to you by United Wireless. It's a series that the road team has seemingly always had the advantage. And last season was that same story. Garden City, hosting Hayes last season after a 3-0 start to the season, were shocked losing 16-0 at the end of the first quarter against this Indians team. Quarterback Caleb Weeksy went just 3 of 7 of the air and was picked off twice in that first quarter. Garden City did as much as they could to try and bring that game back, but at the start of the second half, Malik Bond raced 70-yard passing touchdown to go along with 197 yards on the ground, which puts the Indians to a 30-26 win. Hayes comes into this game with a 2-1 record as well. They had to go to overtime to win in week 1 against Junction City. Now, if you remember Junction City, that is the team that Garden City was knocked out of the playoffs by last season. They won 20-14 on the road. They came back here to Lewis Stadium, which is also the home of the Fort Hayes State Tigers in D2. It is a lovely deal and a beautiful night for football as we are counting down the moments less than 26 minutes away from kickoff here in week 4. Came back here and won their WAC opener in the WAC opener of the season. They're the only team in the WAC with a conference win after they knocked off Great Bend 28-27 here at home. But last week it was a completely different story for this Indians team. On the road against the Manhattan team, down 14-7 after the first quarter, the Indians suffered a serious injury to Malik Baum, which had him sidelined for the rest of the game. 4 interceptions later, Manhattan ran away with it, defeating the Indians 49-7 as Hayes looks to respond tonight. But what does the WAC Conference have in store this season, and what does Brian Hill think of this week's game? We'll have all that and more here on the American Implant Pregame Show. We come back here from Lewis Field. It's the Buffaloes. It's the Indians here in week number 4 of the season. You're listening to Buffaloes Football on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Better with a home policy from American Family Insurance, because you'll feel protected no matter how the wind blows. Also, you can enjoy the home of your dreams and save up to 23% when you bundle home and auto with our expert agents. American Family
Insurance.
Contact Christopher Boyd's agent. Call 620-225-0800 or stop by 2405 Central Avenue in Dodge City.
Here at American Implement, we're proud to be part of the communities we serve, and that's the reason we support local youth through scholastic activities like FFA, 4-H, band, and sports. We firmly believe that the right activity can bring out the best qualities every child has to offer, and we wholeheartedly want to support and be involved with that. It's part of our responsibility as a good neighbor, and we're proud to call your community our home also.
Vehicle maintenance, something Dylan wants to think about. Here at Burtis Motor Company, we make it easy. We do it all, from major engine overhauls to that all-important oil. We also offer complete products and nitrogen for your tires. Our staff, technicians, a full tank, and certified. Using maintenance takes Burtis Motor to a best-deal destination.
The agency in Garden City and Lake are ready to help with your insurance and real estate needs. They offer life, auto, commercial, farm, crop, hail, and multi peril insurance with a variety of companies to choose from. With real estate needs, residential, farm, land, ag, and commercial. Plus, they can help sell and find a home. The agency, 118 East Chestnut in Garden City and 122 North Main in Lincoln. Have a last meal.
Back to Lewis Field here in Hayes, week number 4 of the high school football season, as the Garden City Buffaloes have traveled out to Lewis Field, home of the Fort Hayes State Tigers and the Hayes High School Indians. Welcome back into the American Implant pregame show. You're John Deere, dealer serving all of Western Kansas. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. So last week's game against Wichita West, a great showing for Garden City in a matchup of 2-1-1 teams. Garden City looked like the far better team. And it started on the opening kickoff of the game when setback, Ethan Allen returned the opening kickoff 87 yards down the 3-yard line, which set up Kenny Wynn on the first play from scrimmage for the
Fire Marshal Regulations.
Joined in from 3 yards and gave Garden City the lead. Kenny Wynn was starting in place of Mario Ruiz, who dealt with an injury to his ankle last week. Ruiz is back this week and he's ready to go. Ruiz on the season has rushed for 149 yards and currently lines up 7th in the WAC in rushing yards. The Buffaloes have now scored on each of their opening 3 drives this season, and they scored on their 3rd drive of the game as they marched down the field on 13 plays and 60 yards, instrumented by Kenny Wynn, who pounded in for his 2nd rushing touchdown of the day from 2 yards, which gave the Buffaloes a 14-0 lead going into the 2nd quarter. Wynn last week rushed for 71 yards in that contest after he rushed for 84 yards in Week 2's win over Wichita North. In the 2nd quarter, the Buffaloes really got their explosiveness out. They went on a 7-play, 70-yard touchdown drive where the Buffaloes experimented with a shotgun, found some passes to Ethan Allen and Michael Villalobos, and it was Ethan Allen who had that kickoff return to open up the game. It's a pounded in from 16 yards on a pitch to the nearest sideline. It's Allen's 3rd touchdown in 3 games. He has scored in every game this season. He's the only Buffalo who has found the end zone in each of the first 3 games. And Ethan Gomez, who had a very good performance under center with 125 yards and 3 passing touchdowns the week before, was able to find Braden Sneak, who's turning into his favorite target this season, on a 41-yard touchdown pass over the top, which made it 28-0 Garden City after halftime. Gomez last week went 5-8 through the air with 108 yards, 1 touchdown, and 1 interception. The interception came in the 3rd quarter, and a rough quarter it was for Garden as Ethan Allen muffed the punt, which allowed the Pioneers to set up just outside of the red zone. However, Garden City's defense held. They had a touchdown actually disallowed and were able to get a 4th down sack by Carson Krause to get the Pioneers off the field. Well, the Buffalo's offense tried to march down the field and did, but they were faced with a 4th-and-8 from the 33-yard line. Gomez was forced to try and throw it to the sticks. He was intercepted, and the interception was returned back to the 35-yard line, where the Pioneers were able to find the end zone for their only time as Cameron Wade got a 16-yard touchdown pass from backup quarterback Samir Jackson. But in the 4th quarter, it was the Buffalo's defense who responded with some points. Evan Fitch with the first defensive touchdown of the season, returning an interception 41 yards off of the tip to give the Buffaloes a 35-6 lead. It was Finch's 2nd career touchdown after he had one as a receiver last season in the homecoming game over Ulysses. Yet still, that 3rd quarter wasn't the desired result for Ryan Hill's team as he's still trying to find that killer instinct. He wants to see this team truly finish off games, and here in WAC play, that's going to be a big key. When you look at the WAC so far, Liberals gotten off to their best start since 2003. They are 3-0 on the season. Every team other than Great Banks has a winning record. The Panthers are 1-2 after they lost to this Hayes team. Garden City, Dodge City, and Hayes are all 2-1 on the year. Now across the play in WAC tonight, Liberal and Dodge City as the Red Demons trying to pull the upset and stop that unbeaten start to the season for the Redskins, who will take on Garden City back in Garden City next week. Ryan Hill wants to see that killer instinct come out of this team, and I got the chance to catch up with Coach Hill earlier this week. This pregame interview is brought to you by United Wireless. United Wireless proudly provides Southwest Kansas communities with the latest technologies and services to their customers. Find out why United Wireless is the best value with the best customer service. Now, here's 14th year Buffaloes head coach Ryan Hill. Your team scored last
thing we did. Where does the ability start fast? I think they're just ready to play. We've got some goals to get. The first week, we were pretty methodical. Down the field in the last couple weeks. Come on, big plays, big pass to Ethan, and then Ethan.
Ace High School Athletic Department is proud to recognize Lewis Automotive Group as a sponsor of the Western Athletic Conference Champions Cup. The Champions Cup, established in 2009, is presented annually to the Western Athletic Conference school, which finishes highest in the cumulative points. All sports recognized by the conference in which a champion is crowned are counted towards Champions Cup points. Thank you to Lewis Automotive for their continued support of high school athletics and the communities represented by the Western Athletic Conference.
More success than we've had in quite some time. It's definitely been a weapon for us. We put some really good scoring opportunities. And so that's, you can do that in scoring. We score down on 3 bases in the game. And that's just a pretty good sign.
It's a different game.
It just depends on the game, on the style of players that we had. I mean, last year we were pretty explosive as well. A couple of people back, we necessarily weren't, but I think it just kind of depends on the athletic ability of the kids. And I think you can be successful either way. You know, it's not something that you have to be explosive, but you know, in today's world, that you know, the fewer times you have to snap it before you score, the more efficient you're going to be. When the take is, last week, I got the impression on it, so I get it to work. Well, they had a lot of experience, you know, 4 to 5 starters back. They played next to each other quite a lot of games now, and I really just impressed the way they were doing the game. I think they kind of took that for granted. I think they kind of did that in the second half last week. They just kind of take it for granted that they're just going to continue the success, and they don't sometimes understand that they're one of the big reasons they are successful, because they communicate and understand what the next guy next to them is doing. And I think when they lose that, they kind of lose more consistency.
It takes a lot of effort for a conference to play. It takes a lot of effort to play. How do you think?
Well, it takes a lot of time. I mean, Coach Moore does a great job of it. You know, during practices, working the rules and the combinations that we, you know, run the general system. And I think that it's really important that they, you know, they get that from a young age now. As I said earlier this year, that, you know, most of these guys have been doing it now for 3 years, and they really don't know enough about it. Not having great habits of what they had before. And so, it becomes a little bit more.
And safety incidents at Hayes High School activities. Please be aware of the following implemented expectations and procedures. Middle school students are expected to sit with their parents or sit in the designated Hayes Middle School section on the home side at the north end on the lower level. All elementary students are expected to stay seated with their parents in the stands at the game. No students are allowed in the field track areas or in the end zones. Middle and elementary school students wandering around or playing inside the field and track area during the game will be directed to go back and sit with their parents. Students found to be repeatedly out of the stands will be asked to call their parents to come pick them up. Students cannot bring their own footballs or play equipment into the stadium. There is no re-entry into the game for all students to leave the stadium. These policies will be strictly enforced. Hayes High School thanks you for your cooperation.
Finish all the food on our plate, not just, you know, dabble with it and think around and think it's time to go and, you know, go to bed. We want to have that feeling. But I think that it is impactful. There's not a lot of things that they do in their own life nowadays that you know, that becomes a natural thing. So it has to be explained. We try to a younger age, you know, sometimes the aggressive kid at the really young age, you know, maybe when they're in third grade or something, that they're maturing faster than others, get told to kind of, you know, back off, calm down. And it's not even that they're doing wrong. They're just physically bigger than the kids. And, you know, they get told to back off, back off, back off. They don't hear that for so many years. That when they do, they don't have to come to them at all. And so, you know, just for that, that, you just have to find a fine balance. Because, you know, that's what sports and life to the people. You know, there's a lot of great athletes that are still on the field that are, you know, they look, you know, and they are very intense. You know, they have a hook in their eye, screaming and yelling. You know, they really just have that, you know, killer look on their face, you know, like Tom Brady. But then you put Tom Brady there, you know, and all of a sudden he's steady. You know, like, yeah, he's probably moving. And so that can be a great in that situation, because they don't want kids, you know, that's the hardest thing, is focus, you know, that they don't always necessarily understand the difference. Getting ready for a game when it's 4 o'clock compared to when it's 4 o'clock on a Tuesday, you know, they're just going about their life. They're, you know, unless something changes or somebody tells them differently, they're just going to act however they want to act. And, you know, that's, I think that's, you know, one of those things, you know, you don't act the same way in church as you do at the restaurant. You don't act the same way at your dinner table as you do at the restaurant. You know, they're just you. And I think that's what maturity is. It's not how many birthdays you have. It's can you put yourself in a situation and prepare yourself to act and continue in a manner in which the situation was.
How much maturity does it give back to
you? A lot. Because there's so much back and forth of emotions. You know, the emotions already go high because it's a conference school, so much, you know, knowledge, you know, between coaches and players and teams and sports. You know, they know what they're saying, they know what they're doing, they're in college, and they know so much about each other that, you know, sometimes it's difficult, you know, to get them to, you know, understand that there's going to be a lot of good things that happen, there's going to be a lot of bad things that happen. You can't be getting too excited. And we need to focus when we're doing well, but we also can't have, you know, bear and stand and things are going wrong. We've got to, you know, find a way to come back. So that's the last thing. You know, 20 points early in the game. You can find all the way back. Yeah, that's the right now that I, you know,
defense coordinator Kip Healy. Other assistants, Jay Deckett, Sean Dreling, Kenny Walker, Nathan Hiller, Hayden Chrysler, Pete Harris, and Kyle Hadley. Head coach of the Garden City Buffaloes is Brian Hill.
To feel that, you know, you've got a chance, you know, at a West Championship. And so, but, you know, it is important, and we're not trying to hide that fact from them. We're not, you know, one thing that I try to do.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, would everyone please stand and remove your hats, place your hand over your heart, as our Hayes High Band, under the direction of Mr. Matt Loney, honors our country with the playing of our national anthem.
You know, play games and convince them one way or the other that, hey, this is a big football game, that they're a good football team. And, you know, and again, I don't have to see that, because the kids know that. And that's why I think it's important that you're honest with teenagers and not try to do it for this thing. Yeah, thank you.
Hear those ads for CPARH.
We got it.
Or we'll figure out a way for you to get it if possible. From the do-it-yourselfers to the experienced, CPARH helps you find the products to help you complete your projects. From the farm to town, check with CPARH first before you make that purchase. And while you're there, browse on next door, under the same roof, and check out all the departments in Crazy House. Two great stores under one roof. One stop and you are done. CPARH, North Campus Drive in Garden City. Hey, don't let this sound get you down. Your sweet ride sound like this. Services, computer diagnostic, tire, brake, and suspension service. Plus the best prices and excellent service you can trust. Arzate Auto Repair, 207 North Campus Drive in Garden City. Give a call, 620-277-7789.
Over time, all water wells lose production from plugging by slime, biofilm, mineral incrustations, silts, and clay. All wells should be cleaned periodically. Hydro Resources has the latest equipment and chemicals for cleaning your well. Our high-pressure jetting tool will work loose those plugging materials. This is followed by baling to remove the loosened material and chemical treatment to dissolve it. Call Hydro Resources to learn more about the benefits of cleaning your water well.
We are just about 4 minutes away from football here at Lewis Field as the Garden City Buffaloes take on the Hayes High School Indians. Thank you so much to Coach Brian Hill for joining the American Anthem pregame show. That pregame interview was brought to you by United Wireless. Find out why United Wireless is the best value with the best customer service. Gather here with AWKR 99.9. The Buffaloes take the field here in Hayes, dressed in their scotcher uniforms, all white, white bottoms, white socks, and white helmets to go along with and on the other side of the Hayes Indians already taking the field. They're in their white helmets with yellow uniforms and yellow pants and maroon lettering for the Indians tonight. With these teams in 2-1, these teams do a lot of those similar things on offense. When you look at the Hayes side of things, they have the leading rusher in the entire WAC conference in senior Malik Baugh. Last season, he torched Garden City for 197 yards on the ground and a pair of rushing touchdowns to go along with a 70-yard passing touchdown in that game. Meanwhile, the other side of Garden City, they've got four players in the top 10 in rushing yards, including Kenny Wynn, who was the replacement for Mario Ruiz in the last 2 weeks. He's rushed for 162 yards. Ruiz right behind him at 149 yards. Ethan Allen and Michael Villalobos each over 120 yards on the ground this season. So that brings us into our keys to the game, brought to you by Wheatland Electric, delivering energy for life, a touchstone energy cooperative. That's Wheatland Electric. The key for Garden City tonight is going to have to be to win the front on the defensive line. If they are able to make things difficult on Malik Baugh, who is currently a game-time decision for this Indians team after he suffered an injury last week in Manhattan. Ian McGuire, their backup running back who went last week, is out. This is a team that's going to try a pair of other running backs tonight, including Carter Graham, their quarterback and running back, Derek Walk, or Harley Zimmerman, who are two linebackers on the team. The JV running back is Jace Myers. He also could see time tonight. That's because this is a Hayes team that is very short-handed, and last week when Ba went down. It forced them to go to the air in Manhattan. We're able to drop eight in coverage and pick off the starting quarterback for the Indians, Carter Graham, four times. Graham comes in tonight with 241 yards, two touchdowns, and six interceptions, the fourth fewest passing yards of any quarterback in this conference, only above Ethan Gomez, who has 238 yards, albeit Gomez only on 17 attempts. Graham, 21 of 54 through the air. We are almost ready for football. We'll take a short break and be right back here from Lewis Field. It's the Buffaloes. It's the Indians. It's coming up here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Indians will toss and defer to the second half. Garden City will be receiving the start to football.
The mission of the Casinetti Group is to make your insurance experience convenient, simple, and affordable. They would meet a welcoming staff and people that really care about them and want to, you know, help them with their needs, whatever that might be. What is most satisfying about what I do is our clients. Bottom line, I love just watching our clients grow and get to be part of their life.
Tonight from Lewis Field is week four of the crack season. The opener for the North City Buffaloes in WAC Conference play is the 2-1 Buffs. It's the 2-1 Hayes Indians and a packed Lewis Field. It's beautiful football, 82 degrees here in Hayes and Ellis County. Not a cloud in the sky at the home of the Fort Hayes State Tigers. It was the Indians, the home team, who won the toss and deferred to the second half. So the Buffaloes will get this game getting started, going from left to right across your radio. The Indians in their home yellow uniforms and white helmets will set it right to left across the radio dot. For the Indians, it'll be 5'9 senior Harley Zimmerman to send this one away. Michael Villalobos and Ethan Allen standing by at the Garden City 10-yard line, waiting to get this one started. Big game for both of these teams. Zimmerman steps forward and sends this one away towards the left zone. We are underway from Lewis Field. Being returned by Villalobos on the left side of the field, cuts in front of the 25-yard line, is taken down at the 26. And that's where Garden City will open this game up. Quarterback Ethan Gomez leads the Buffaloes out on the field today. So far this season, 9 of 17 through the air for 242 yards, 4 passing touchdowns, and 2 interceptions with a 25-yard net total on the ground and 1 rushing touchdown. So the Buffaloes have been on the 26-yard line. Garden City scoring 35 points last week in the win over North. They have scored in each of their 3 opening drives to start this season. They'll go 2 wide receivers on the near side, and Brady Sleeve in the slot with Emilio Zunt along the far sideline. First down and 10. They send Ethan Allen in motion. The pitch is down along the near side. He's upended in the backfield for a big-time tackle for loss. Dalton Myers, who is the leader in the conference in tackles for loss coming into tonight. That's his 7th of the season.
With the tackle.
They'll say loss of 6 for Ethan Allen, so the Buffaloes go to the ground on their first play, but can't do anything with it. Allen's the only Buffalo who has scored in all 3 games so far this season. He had a 16-yard touchdown run last week in the 35-6 win over Wichita West. So the Buffaloes lose 8 yards on that play. They say 2nd down and 18 as they have at the 19-yard line. One wide receiver leads sign for Gomez, who hands it off in the middle to Mario Ruiz. He gets back to the 20-yard line, nothing more, nothing less. Gain of 1 for the junior who missed last week's game due to an injury. Last season had 290 yards, which was 4th amongst Buffaloes, and 5 rushing touchdowns. He's already got 3 rushing touchdowns in 2 games this season.
With 17
so it's
going to
be 3rd and very long, 16 to go. As it's down to the 20-yard line, the Buffalo is going to have to get it all the way up to about the 36-yard line here. One wide receiver to each side. It's Sneath to the far and Zunt to the near. Hayes with 5 across the defensive line. Gomez takes the snap, pitches out to Villalobos along the far sideline. Past the 20 and upended at the 24-yard line. It'll be a 3-and-out for Garden City to open the game. Dante Younger, the senior, with the tackle, and nothing going for the Buffaloes on the opening possession.
Number 28, Dante Younger with the tackle.
This is exactly what this Hayes defense would have wanted to do, because they gave up 42 points defensively last week, losing 49-7. The only other point was on a deflected pick six by Manhattan.
Eddie Rodriguez
will send this one away left to right. It's a low pick angling towards the Hayes sideline that bounces out of bounds around midfield. And the Indians will get great field position to start this game. So a big development right now. Malik Baugh, who was a game-time decision, has not taken the field right now. It'll be Carter Graham, the quarterback, to lead this team out. Zane Viagra, who is the backup quarterback on this team, currently lining up at running back. As some of the officials are exchanging game balls at midfield. Carter Graham so far in the season, 21 of 54, the worst completion percentage in the WAC, at 38.9. With 241 yards, two passing touchdowns, and six interceptions. Last week, he was 11 of 20 for 122 yards, one passing touchdown, and four INTs. First and 10 here for the Indians at midfield here. 10-23 to go in the opening quarter, no score. Indians come out a pistol. Two wide receivers out to the far sideline are Johnny Cano and Jarek Purdy, the two leading receivers on this team. Graham takes the snap, takes a two-step drop to throw. Throws out to the far sideline, caught by Cano, their leading receiver. Break past the 40-yard line, inside the 35 for a Hayes first down. There is a flag down. That could be 47-yard line, so we'll see what the flag is. It came from the far line judge, which is around where the Garden City fans have come. Plenty of brown shirts making the visit, about 2 hours and 15 minutes it took me from Garden today. Clock stops with 10:17. If it stands, it's going to be a gain of 19 yards.
We asked if he's ever flying the drone over the field. You need to land that.
Brian O making his way over to talk to one of the side judges, and the Indians team appears to be moving back. So I believe this one might be a holding. We don't have an official call yet. Buffaloes went 3-and-out on their opening possession. Garden City 2-1 on the season. It's the first time the Buffaloes haven't scored on an opening drive in their first three games. As here comes the call momentarily. There's two penalties on the play. I believe an illegal shift was called, but also a holding penalty. So a loss of down.
Illegal
and a 5-yard penalty on illegal procedure, Moves the Indians back, so they will go all the way back to the 45 here. On first and 15, that's what it's saying on the sideline. Now they'll make the change, so it is a loss down. So second down and 15, not the start that the Indians wanted, but they're still in good field position, threatening their own 45-yard line. Pistol set up again, the handoff is to Viagra right up on the right side, and he'll get about 4 yards on the play to make it third down and manageable. So Viagra operating as a backup quarterback in this game.
He's got number 12, Holden Plankenhorn
making time for the Garden City. Plankenhorn comes into tonight, tied for third in the WAC in total tackles, two behind Trenton Byrne for second. So it'll be third down and 11 for the Indians at their own 49-yard line. They're going to get it to the Garden City 40. Pistol sent, two wide receivers to the near side, one to the far. Graham takes the snap. Plenty of time in the pocket as he's trying to throw. Fires near sideline, too far and incomplete. He was trying to hit Cano on the out route. Good coverage on the play by Evan Finch. And it's decision time here for the Indians. Fourth down and 11 coming up. Looks like the offense staying on the field right now. And it looks like the Indians could go for this. Now, they do use Graham as a punter, so we'll see what they do here. But right now it's fourth down 11. They line up in the shotgun, and flags come in. False start penalty here against Hayes. That'll make it an even tougher fourth down trying to
convert. Against the Indians.
So two penalties on this opening drive, technically three against Hayes, two of which were called on the same plays, only two of them being enforced. And Ethan Allen will now come out and set up as a punt returner right now at the 30-yard line now. As mentioned, they use Graham as their punter, so they're set up in a shotgun right now. They could drop out of it. Now we'll take a couple steps back, receive the snap, take one step forward, and send this one away. It's a booming kick out towards the nearest sideline. Takes it out to the 19, rolling towards the end zone. It's going to be close, and Hayes will down it. It might have rolled across the goal line. Right now it's being down at the 1-yard line, and it's down at the 2.
Nice action by the Indians. Ball is down inside the 5-yard line.
Two-yard line. Excellent special teams work there by the Indians. They go 3 and out. So both teams going 3 and out here as we open up this game. 9:07 to go in the first quarter. No score here in the WAC opener for the Garden City Buffaloes. Second WAC game for Hayes as
first
they
down,
take down Great Bend
28-27.
This drive starts all the way back at the 2-yard line after an excellent punt by quarterback Carter Grant. Well, Buffalo's done a great job this season with their offensive line. They're going to have to do some work here as they want to avoid a safety here with 9:07 to go in the first. Villalobos goes in motion. The handoff goes up the middle to Ruiz, who finds a gap and gets to the 6-yard line for a 4-yard gain. That's exactly what Garden City was looking for right there. Just get them out of safety territory and get some sort of positive gain after their first play of the second drive, which would be the first drive, went for a loss of 8 yards. Mario Ruiz did not play in this game last season against Hayes. It was a 30-26 win for the Indians back at Buffalo Stadium. They led 16-0 after the first quarter, and the Buffaloes did as much as they could to try and rally in that game. Now they go one wide receiver to each side here, second down and 6 for the Buffs. It's a handoff that goes straight up the middle to Ruiz, and he is swarmed by the Indians. Nowhere to go. Wyatt Kirkpatrick leads the way, the junior who leads the WAC with 35 tackles coming into tonight. And it'll make it 3rd and 6. Mario Ruiz coming back from that ankle injury. Missed last week. Did not play too much.
With 7 yards
in
to go.
Garden City's win over Wichita North in week 2. And this is someone who's going to be such a key player for them this season. After he had 78 yards and 2 touchdowns in the first road game this season against Wichita Heights. 3rd down and 6, they'll call it. Allen in motion, the handoff is to Ruiz, trying to bounce to the outside. He does, and he gets to the 8-yard line before he stood up, and that'll bring up 4th down. So just nothing going for this Buffaloes team on their first two possessions. Back to that 3 and outs as they try to run the ball 6 times. And the Indians doing a very good job holding Mario Ruiz down. So the Buffaloes will punt. Eddie Rodriguez will go out to punt, and for the second time, most likely, Hayes are going to get it in great field position as Jarrett Purdy, the sophomore, drops back to receive this punt. Rodriguez in his own end zone sends this one away straight up the middle of the field. Takes a bounce at the 38. Purdy will return, fakes the lateral, running along the near sideline 40. Past the 35, 30, 25, 20. Purdy back into the middle of the field, upended by the punter at the 15-yard line. Hayes with a bit of trickery there as Purdy faked the pitch to Cooper Lindenmeyer, got great blocks along the near sideline, and returns it into the red zone.
Number 33, Eddie Rodriguez.
So for the second time, Hayes will start in plus field position. This time it will start at the Garden City 15 here with 7 minutes to go in the first quarter. Hayes are in the Lewis Automotive Group red zone. Lewis Automotive, your home of drivers in Southwest Kansas. First down and 10 for the Indians, who line up in pistol. 2 wide receivers to the near side, 1 to the front. Indians have still yet to complete a pass today. They are 0-for-1. They did try a pass, which worked for 19 yards in the first play, but it was called back due to an illegal motion penalty. Snap to Graham, who throws incomplete for Cano. Trying to hit the curl route to the leading receiver for this
13, Johnny Cano.
Indians team. Comes in with 13 receptions on the season. Now, he's not the leading receiving yards leader. That belongs to Jarrett Purdy, who's got 123 yards and 2 touchdowns on the season. And he just had that big punt return to set up Hayes. It's 7th down and 10, ball at the 15-yard line of Garden City. Graham now 0-for-2 through the air. Pistol set up again, 1 wide receiver to the near side and 2 in the farm. Handoff goes straight up the middle to Bianca, finds a hole between the left guard and the center, and moves his way inside the 10-yard line to around the 6. It'll be interesting to see where they spot it. I believe right now it's a 3rd down and short. So no Malik Baugh tonight, at least from what we've seen for this Indians team. They do say gain of 9 yards on the play. 3rd down and 1. Wide receiver to the near side is Mokel. Takes the snap. Viagra trying to bounce to the outside, and he has stood up around the line of scrimmage. I think he's short.
Viagra carries once again for the Indians.
Colton Blankenhorn helped to finish off the tackle. A few other Buffaloes. David Holguin in on the tackle.
He's right down.
I believe it's 4th down and 1.
Number 33, Eddie Rodriguez.
and he is short. No gain on the play. Here comes the big play early on in this ball game. 6:23 to go here in the first quarter. No score between Hayes and Garden City. The Indians will have 4th and 1 from the 6-yard line as it stands. And now they're going to measure it. And by the looks of the spot, I think he might have it. But here comes the official ruling.
Official time for measurement.
It's down near the 5-yard line. And it is a first down. They only needed one and they just about got it. It'll be 1st and goal. As Viagra has now carried 3 times for 11 yards in this game. And as the clock will resume momentarily, it's 1st and goal from the 5-yard line here for Hayes. They'll let you out the backfield as Viagra is the quarterback right now. He is the backup quarterback on the roster officially. He takes the snap. It's a power to the left side. Bounces off of one tackle, and then it's taken down in the backfield. Dio Holguin leads the charge. He's bringing down by Carson Krause. A loss on 1st and goal.
He's brought down to number 33, Eddie Rodriguez. And number 53,
it's a power off to the left side. This is a Hayes team that's going to try a lot of different things on offense tonight. So now operating with Viagra as their goal line quarterback. As Carter Graham is no longer on the field, he's along the Hayes near sideline. Clock winds to 5:40 to go in the opening quarter. 2 wide receivers out to each side. He sends a man in motion. It's Cano. He pitches to Cano along the far sideline. Cuts back into the middle. Inside the 5. It is upended by Rodriguez and a couple of different Buffaloes around the 4-yard line. It'll make it 3rd and goal. And now Carter Graham will return to the field.
He's tackled by number 10, Braden Dibble. And number 56, Sebastian Lopez.
So a big-time play coming up here for Hayes.
3rd and goal.
They'll say
1 yard
gain on the play. So they will say 3rd down and goal from the 5. As Graham returns to the field, so far Graham is 0-for-2 through the air with one completion that was called back due to a penalty. 2 wide receivers to the near side, 1 to the far in the pistol. Halfway done here in the first quarter. Takes the snap, hands off to Viagra, right up the middle, and he plows into the end zone for an Indians touchdown. They get the ball at the 15-yard line. It took them some time, but they find the end zone. And Hayes leads 6-0 here with 4:54 to go in the first. So a 6-point, 15-yard touchdown drive has put Hayes in front. First time all season the Buffaloes have trailed first. Zimmerman on for the extra point, the snap, the hold, the kick is a line drive straight through the uprights. A great return by Jarrett Purdy sets up the Indians in prime field position. They take advantage as sophomore running back Zane Viagra gives the Indians the lead. 4:54 to go in the opening quarter. Hayes 7, Garden City 0 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
When was the last time your family had their best day ever? Come to Garden City, Kansas, where you can slide, splash, and play this summer. The all-new Garden Rapids at the Big Pool, thrills and chills for the whole family. Parrot Cove Indoor Water Park, where there's something for everyone. No matter what the weather, we have you covered. Garden City, Kansas has the coolest spots under the sun. Make a splash.
Linesman Adam Albers, Judge Chris Rohr, and back Judge Sam Williams.
6-play, 15-yard touchdown drive for Hayes as the Indians hit front here at home. A 4-yard rushing touchdown by sophomore Zane Viagra has put Hayes 7-0 in front. Cal Friedman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Both teams with a pair of 3 and outs to open up this game. The Indians with their first big play of the game on special teams as they return a punt roughly 35 yards, set them up in the red zone. Buffalo's defense did as much as they could. They got the Indians to 3rd and goal. Eventually it was Viagra who pounds it in. He's turned back out for his 2nd kickoff tonight. He'll go from right to left across your radio down. Garden City lost the coin toss and Hayes deferred to the 2nd half. Zimmerman sends a line drive kick straight at Villalobos. He makes the catch on 14 along the left hash. Passes the 25-yard line to the 30 and steps out of bounds at 31-yard line. To the best field position here for Garden City to open up this game.
With the kickoff return, forced out of bounds by number 17, Evan Cosgrove.
This is a Garden City team that when I talked to Brian Hill earlier this week, and if you were listening on the American pregame show, he said he's never had this much confidence in a special teams unit off the kickoffs. He said they need to use that be able to strike some fear into opponents. And so far today, it's been line drive kicks. Hayes haven't looked afraid so far. So Ethan Gomez leads the offense back on the field. He's still yet to attempt a pass in this game. Garden City has ran six plays, all of which runs. We'll see if they change that here as they'll go one wide receiver to each side. It's sneak to the far and zip to the near. Here, first down and 10 at the 31. Villalobos goes in motion. Gomez will throw for the first time. Under pressure along the right end. Steps up, throws deep down the field. Tipped up high and caught! Caught by Sneak at the 36-yard line.
Pass is complete.
Great job by Gomez to avoid the pressure of Tim McCautry. Stepped up and had one tipped up in the air by Johnny Rigler. And Sneak makes a big catch downfield. So they spot the ball all the way up at 37. Sometimes you'd rather be lucky than good if you're Ethan Gomez, who finds his favorite target on the season. Now they come out and shotgun with a bunch out to the near sideline, first down and 10. They pitch out to Ruiz, who cuts back in front of one tackler and is upended after a gain of one. When I talked to Brian Hill about Braden Sneath earlier this week, he said you wouldn't know he's around at practice because he hardly speaks. But that being said, he proved that he can be a deep threat for us. And in our offense, we don't just need first downs, we need touchdowns. And that's Sneath's third catch of the season. His first two had gone for touchdowns. And that one for a big gainer all the way up to the 37. They say 1 yard gain for Ruiz. So now second down and 9 for the Buffaloes as they're operating in plus territory for the first time tonight, trailing 7-0 here with 4 minutes to go. Villalobos goes in motion towards the far sideline. He gets the pitch on a speed option, trying to get some good blocks. Does get a good block, gets past the 35-yard line, and then goes down at the 33-yard line. Wrapped up on play by Cyrus Johnson, the senior. And it'll bring up third down and manageable here for Garden City.
3 yards on the play.
First carry of the night for Villalobos, who's come into tonight with roughly 170 yards all-purpose this season. He had 48 receiving yards last week in that 35-6 win against Wichita West. Third down and 6 here for the Buffaloes after that gain of 3. Allen goes in motion, movement along the line of scrimmage, and the flags fly. Garden City is motioning that it's going to be an offsides penalty. If it is, it would make it 3rd and 1. And it is an offsides against the Indians. And that is a huge penalty. It's the 3rd already against Hayes. And that changed it from a 3rd and 6 to a 3rd and 1. Here for the Buffaloes, the ball will be down at the 28-yard line. They've got to get it to the 27th. And someone who's so good in short yardage situations in Mario Ruiz, back in the backfield after missing last week. One wide receiver to each side here, 3rd down and 1. As Hayes crowd the offensive line, Ruiz gets the ball and he gets the first down. Went straight up the middle between the left guard and the center of Zach Pitch and Andrew Moreno. Needed one, I believe he got 3. It's a first down for Garden City.
Cyrus Johnson. And number 48.
Cyrus Johnson on the tackle for the Indians.
First down.
6 foot, 210-pound senior playing at the defensive end. As the clock winds under 3 minutes to go here in the opening quarter, Garden City trails 7-0 off of the Viagra rushing touchdown. But the Buffaloes, after a big play from Ethan Gomez downfield to Braden Steve on a ricochet, will have it at the 26-yard line. They're going to bunch in the formation as Steve lined up to the left side and Steve to the right, or to the Zunt to the right. And in motion, Villalobos. He gets the pitch along the far sideline. A good block by Allen and a stiff arm as he goes out of bounds after 2. So far, Garden City's trying to go more east-west on this drive. They've thrown a couple more pitches than they did in the first two drives. But after a big pass play, it's now a 4-play drive for this Buffaloes team, who really got enforced by that offsides penalty. So gain of 2 for Michael Villalobos, the junior, who only had 5 touches in his sophomore season, but he took them for 107 yards, averaging 21.4 yards per carry, and nobody on last year's Buffalo team averaged over 11.5. Second down and 9 here at the 25 of Hayes. Allen goes in motion, Gomez looking to throw, steps up in the pocket and taken down for a sack. Offensive line just didn't hold a coverage sack there by the Indians, as Wyatt Kirkpatrick is the one wheeling away in celebration. He has had some season so far. Through the first 3 games of the year, Kirkpatrick leading the WAC with 35 tackles and 4 tackles for loss. Hayes have the 2 leaders in tackles for loss this season in Dalton Myers and Wyatt Kirkpatrick. But Garden City has the 3 leaders in sacks in Carson Krause, Dio, and David Holden. It's a loss of 5 on the play. Third down and 14 here for the Buffalo. You come out shotgun. Snap to Gomez, bootleg to the nearest sideline. An H1, looking, fires underneath, finds Suntz. At the 25-yard line, jukes out towards the 20, and he is going to be short of the first down, but it's going to be close.
They'll
be down to the 20-yard line, so it's going to set up a fourth down and 4 in decision time here for the Buffaloes.
Along with Tanner Geis and on with the shot. It's fourth down.
First catch of the night for Emilio Zunt, who enters tonight with 48 yards and a touchdown through the air. So gain of 10, and it's going to be a big fourth down and 4 for the Buffaloes. They down the ball at the 20-yard line. The Buffaloes were in the red zone, brought to you by the Lewis Automotive Group. Lewis Automotive, your home of drivers in Southwest Kansas. And with this big decision coming up, the Buffaloes are going to burn their first timeout. Well, big play coming up when we come back. 1:10 to go in the opening quarter. We'll take a short 30-second break. It's the Buffalo 0 and the Indians 7 here on KWKR 999 The Rock.
At Lewis Automotive Group, we take pride in putting together the best team. We have a knowledgeable sales staff to best represent us, and we recruit and train the best technicians available to make sure you are taken care of after the sale. So come see us and join our winning team.
I'm Ochak Baji.
I am Christian Brown.
I'm David McCormick.
Come join the winning Lewis team like I did.
Buy local, buy for less, buy Lewis.
Third possession of the night for the Buffaloes, and a big play coming up in this ball game. As it stands, it's a fourth down and 4 for the Buffaloes at the Hayes 20-yard line, trailing 7-0 with 1:10 to go in the opening quarter. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. So far, it's a 7-play drive coming up with 2 big completions for Ethan Gomez. As on the first play of this drive, a 43-yard pass downfield. Took a ricochet and was caught by Braden Sneak. And recently on 3rd and 14, the Buffaloes with a 10-yard completion from Gomez to Emilio Zunt. So the Buffaloes will go for it here. They'll go one wide receiver to each side, the triple option formation. The side backs are Ethan Allen to the left and Villalobos to the right. Mario Ruiz, the halfback. Gomez looking to throw on 4th down and 4. The wheel route for Allen is caught at the 3-yard line, first and goal. Pinpoint pass by Ethan Gomez, running it through for Allen, and it's first and goal for the Buffaloes.
First and goal, Buffaloes.
And Ethan Gomez now 3-for-3 for about 70 yards on this drive as the junior is leading the Buffaloes down the field. First and goal for Garden City at the 3-yard line, trailing 7-0, under a minute to go here in the first quarter. One wide receiver to each side. Villalobos in motion, handoff to Ruiz, powering his way into the end zone and short at the 1. Didn't quite stretch the ball out, so it's going to be second and goal from the 1-yard line. So that is already the 6th carry for Ruiz. He hasn't gone for more than 4 yards on the ground. But he has been chunking up yards, or that's what he normally does. Missed last week due to that ankle injury. So the Buffaloes have it at the goal line here. Second and goal from the 1. Down 7, trying to tie this ball game up before the end of the first quarter. Same formation, one wide receiver to each side. Gomez sends Villalobos in motion, gives it to Ruiz, straight up the cut. He's in for 6.
Touchdown.
The ball came out at the end, but the far line judge already had put his hands up. Touchdown, Garden City. 4th of the season for Mario Ruiz, and with 13 seconds to go in the opening quarter, the Buffs are an extra point away from tying this game up. 7-6 Hayes. 4th touchdown for Mario Ruiz, who now has rushed in from 11 yards, 7 yards, and 2 1-yard rushes, respectively. Eddie Rodriguez on for the PAT. He was 5-for-5 last week after going 10-for-10. Yes, 10-for-10 in week 2 against Wichita North. Holder will be Emilio Zunt. Snap, the hold, the kick is on its way, and this kick is good.
Extra point.
An excellent drive down the field by the Buffaloes. 3 big-time passes by Ethan Gomez, and a 1-yard touchdown rush by Mario Ruiz. 13 seconds to go in the opening quarter from Lewis Field. It's Garden City 7 and Hayes 7 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
There's some reason we're all here. To create an amazing experience for each life we touch. If we look closely, we might just see there's something about you amazing people. These amazing drinks served this amazingly fast. There's just something about Scooter's Coffee.
69-yard touchdown drive by the Garden City Buffaloes, which takes 4:36 off the clock and ends with the fourth rushing touchdown of the season by junior Mario Ruiz. Tie ball game here at Lewis Field, the home of the Fort Hays State Tigers and the Hays Indians, as Hays will get the ball back for their third time tonight at the game side for his second time. Eddie Rodriguez, who just made the PAT, will send this one off left to right across your radio now. Two men back deep for Hays are Jarek Purdy and Johnny Canna. Rodriguez strides forward and sends this one away with his left foot. It's a line drive kick that will be fielded by one of the up backs who muffs it. Gets it back at the 16-yard line, now running along the near sideline over the middle of the field. Upended at the 28-yard line. The ball came out at the end. Garden City believes they have it, still waiting for an official signal. And it remains with Hays. It was fielded by Cyrus Johnson, the up back, taken down by his knees, and the ball did come out in the end, but the Indians fortunately fall back on it. So 3 seconds to go in the opening quarter. It'll be the last play of the first quarter, unless penalty, as the Indians take over their worst field position of the day at the 29-yard line. He's got the ball at midfield on their first possession, then got it at the 15 on their second. Carter Graham in the pistol set with Viagra, the touchdown score tonight behind him. Two wide receivers to the far, one to the near, and the tight end along the right side of the offensive line. Graham takes the snap, looking to throw. Garden City with a late blitz. Throws one deep down the right sideline. Too far and incomplete. Looking downfield for Jarek Purdy. Good coverage downfield by Emilio Zutz. And that brings an end to an exciting opening quarter. Well, the Hays got that 35-yard kickoff return, or excuse me, the punt return, which set them up for a 4-yard rushing touchdown by Zane Diego. Garden City marches down the field 69 yards, and Mario Ruiz pounds in from 1 yard. 12 minutes down, 36 to go here from Lewis Field. Tie ball game at 7 in the WAC opener for the Buffaloes here on KWKR 99.9 The WAC. Second quarter here from Lewis Field. Tie ball game at 7 as the Indians have it at their own 29-yard line here. Second down and 10. Graham takes the snap, hands it off to Diego. He's got a big hole on the right side of the offensive line. The ball comes in at the end. It's still loose, and Garden City's got it at the 40-yard line. Big punch out by Garden City. Emilio Zutt with a fist pump at midfield, and the Buffaloes force the first turnover of tonight's ball game. It was a run of 11 for the man who scored the touchdown in the opening quarter. And now the Buffaloes take over in plus field position. Downs at the 40. Cal Friedman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Viagra got the opening touchdown in that quarter on a 4-yard rush. Margo Ruiz scoring from 1 yard out on Garden City's last drive, which went 9 plays, 69 yards in 4:36, as they now take over for the first time here in the second quarter. At the Hays 40, first down and 10. Bunch set for Garden City. Allen goes in motion towards the near sideline to give this to Ruiz, moving along the right side of the offensive line. He's going to get maybe one, nothing more, nothing less. Seventh carry already in this game for Ruiz, who's now 12 yards on the ground, but he does have that crucial touchdown, his fourth of the season. Right, his mother's score is also to give you across our family of networks here at the Western Kansas Broadcast Center. TMP and Scott are scoreless at the end of the first quarter. And in the WAC, Dodge City hosting Liberal at 3-0. Both those teams scoreless. That out-of-town scoreboard update is brought to you by Crazy House, the Hoop King of Kansas. Gain of 1 for Ruiz on the last play. It'll be 2nd down and 9 for the Buffaloes at the Hays 39-yard line. Sneak out in motion as the single back set. Handoff goes to Ruiz, and he is stood up in the backfield. absolutely nowhere to go. Wyatt Kirkpatrick jumped the snap at the perfect time. He came in tonight with four tackles for loss on the season. He's now got a sack in a TFL, and it'll be third down and long. Ruiz had hardly even gotten the handoff before Kirkpatrick blew his way into the backfield. Coming in tonight, leading the WAC with 35 solo tackles on the season. They'll say loss of two for Ruiz on that last play. It'll be third down and 11 here for the Buffaloes, down at the Hayes 41-yard line, trying to take advantage after that fumble. Buffaloes will come out in the flex zone set. One wide receiver to each side. Sneaks from the near zone to the far. Play action for Gomez. He's looking. Fires along the far sideline. Completes to Solis, and he's just short of the first down. He caught it on the curl. It was Villalobos, excuse me, for an 11-yard gain. As it stands, it's just short. It'll be fourth and inches, and the Buffaloes are going to go for it. So Gomez is already 4 for 4 through the air, as Villalobos, who came in tonight with 43 receiving yards, has a gain of 11. It's a fourth and about a hair here with 9:30 to go in the second quarter. Tied ball game at 7. Buffaloes will crowd the offensive line. Not one player more than 7 yards behind the football. Handoff goes to Ruiz. He's got the first down along the left side of the offensive line and moves his way to the 28-yard line. Well, just give the ball to big number 8 when you need those short yarded situations. He already had a third down pickup on the last drive, and now the Buffaloes will operate first down and 10. Ball down at the 28-yard line. So Ruiz now up to 15 yards on the ground tonight, as the Buffaloes trying to take their first lead of the night here, 9 minutes to go in the opening half here from Lewis Field. One wide receiver to each side. Allen goes in motion. Gomez looking to throw. Pressure in his face, and he's taken down at the 35-yard line. Another sack for Hayes, and Dalton Myers makes his way into the backfield. Second sack of the night for this Indians defense, who has come out with a point to prove after giving up 42 points last week against Manhattan. Second and 17. They started the season on a phenomenal start, 14 points in an overtime win. At Junction City, they came back here to Lewis Field. They gave up 27 in a WAC conference win over Great Bend. So loss of 7 on the sack. Back to the 35-yard line, second down and 17. One wide receiver to each side here for the Buffaloes. The play clock is winding down, and Brian Hill is going to have to use a second timeout here of the opening half. So clock stops with 8:12 to go. We'll take a 30-second timeout. Tied ball game at 7. The Buffaloes have it in Hayes territory here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
The mission of the Casnetti Group is to make your insurance experience convenient, simple, and affordable. They would meet a welcoming staff and people that really care about them and want to, you know, help them with their needs, whatever that might be. What is most satisfying about what I do is our clients. Bottom line, I love just watching our clients grow and get to be part of their life.
Welcome back to Lewis Field, the home of the Fort Hayes High School Tigers and the Hayes High School Indians. Time ball game at 7 with 8:12 to go here in the second quarter. The Buffaloes just using their second timeout after a sack against Ethan Gomez. We remind you here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock, if you want to call in and find out any of the final scores from across Kansas tonight, or give your opinion on one of the games that you might have watched in person, be sure to tune in to Aaron Elam with the Southwest Kansas Sports Wrap-Up, which will go live right after the Robinson Furniture post-game show here on 99.9 The Rock. So after the 7-yard sack, it'll be second down and 17 for the Buffaloes. You have it at the 35-yard line. Shotgun set for Gomez. Ruiz, the running back at the right hip. Three wide receivers here to the near side. Gomez takes the snap, hands it off to Ruiz. Off of the outside tackle and nowhere to go. Lost a yard on the play. The Indians have been great at the line of scrimmage tonight. As Derek Watt, the senior, makes the tackle, it'll be third down and very long. So that's already 12 carries for Ruiz in this ball game. He's at about 14 yards. He just hasn't been able to get it moving on the ground. And a third and very long here for Garden City. They'll say no gain on the play. He got back to the line of scrimmage. Third and 17 here for Garden City. Ethan Gomez has been great through the air tonight, 4 for 4 with a long of 43 to Braden Seat. They punch in the formation here on 3rd and 17. They fake the pitch, bootleg out to the far sideline. He throws underneath, pass caught by Sneed at the 25-yard line. Angling his way to the yards today, and he gets the first down at about the 16-yard line before he's pushed out of bounds. They needed 17, and I believe they got 20 on Sneed's second big catch of the ball game. And look at the way that Ethan Gomez has opened up tonight. 43 yards, 10 yards, 17 yards, 11 yards, and 20 yards through the air, excuse me. As they down it at the 16-yard line, the Buffaloes are now in the Lewis Automotive Group red zone. Lewis Automotive, your home of drivers East Southwest Kansas. First down and 10 for the Buffaloes after the big third down conversion at the 16-yard line. One wide receiver to each side. Gomez takes the snap, pitches it to Ethan Allen. Running along the 15-yard line, far sideline, excuse me, he's taken down at the 11.
Pitch to number 9, Ethan Allen.
Second time Allen's got the ball. He got the ball in the first play of the game, went backwards for 6.
Johnny Rager,
he picks up about Jared 5 Rocken, or 6 there. Allen came in tonight with 128 rushing yards and a pair of rushing touchdowns. Also 2 receptions for 85 yards and a touchdown. He also had a 17-yard catch earlier on in this game. As Ethan Gomez has looked absolutely phenomenal through the air tonight. Gain of 5 for Allen on that last play. Second down and 5 for the Buffaloes at the Hayes 11-yard line. Searching their first lead of the night. 6:43 to go here in the opening half. Gomez pitches to Allen, running along the far sideline, has the first down, and he's taken out of bounds near the 5-yard line.
Number 9, Ethan Allen. First out of bounds, number 44, Derek Walk.
It was Derek Walk who had that sack a couple plays ago who upends him, and they're going to say that it's going to be a first down, and they down the ball at the 6-yard line. So they needed 5 and got 5, and Allen has the chains moving again for Garden City. Both these teams are 2-1 on the season. Garden City's WAC conference opener. Hayes is 1-0 in conference play after they beat Great Bend here at Lewis Field earlier. Handoff on first and goal goes to Ruiz, and he is pushed backwards. Forward progress might get him down about the 8-yard line. He went down at the 10. We'll see where they spot. Mario Ruiz in his return has not been able to rush for more than 4 yards tonight, but he does have the lone touchdown of this game. It's a loss of 2.
Loss of a couple yards on the play. Second,
so second and goal for the Buffaloes here at the 8-yard line. 6:10 to go here in the opening half. 7-7 between the Buffaloes and the Indians. Flexbone set, one wide receiver to each side. Allen goes in motion. The pitch is to Allen. Trying to long along the far sideline. And upended at the 10. Another tackle for a loss for the Indians.
Allen carries for the Buffaloes.
Just nowhere to go on the pitch to the far sideline. Kirkpatrick swarming in again, along with Cam Jones. It'll be third down and goal from the 10. The Buffaloes have yet to attempt a field goal this season. For Eddie Rodriguez, who is 16 for 16 on PATs. He didn't make one in the opening week. As Buffaloes have 13 seconds to get the playoff, winding down to 10. Ethan Gomez still has not left the sideline for Brian Hill. And I believe the Buffaloes are going to have to take their third timeout of the half. And that which they will do. So third and goal from the Buffaloes from the 10 when we come back. 5:22 to go in the opening half. It's Hayes 7 and Garden City 7. We'll take a 30-second break here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
When was the last time your family had their best day ever? Come to Garden City, Kansas, where you can slide, splash, and play this summer. The all-new Garden Rapids at the Big Pool. Thrills and chills for the whole family. Parrot Cove Indoor Water Park, where there's something for everyone. No matter what the weather, we have you covered. Garden City, Kansas has the coolest spots under the sun. Make a splash.
Buffaloes out of timeouts here with 5:22 to go in the opening half, but they have it third down and goal from the 10-yard line of Hayes, trying to take their first lead of the ball game. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock here live from Lewis Field, week 4 of the season for Garden City, who will return next week for their home conference opener as they take on the current 3-0 Liberal Redskins. Last time we checked, Liberal scoreless against Dodge City tonight in their conference opener. Liberal starting 3-0 for the first time since 2003. We talked about it earlier today on the morning roundup. Brooks Kaplan, their quarterback, has been phenomenal. He will be the key all of next week as the Buffaloes trying to take a 3-1 record home here. Tie ball game at 7. Your third down and goal for the Buffs at the Indian 10-yard line with 5:22 to go in the second quarter. Flex bone formation, one wide receiver to each side. Gomez goes in motion. Gomez takes the snap. Finds a wide open Ruiz at the five, angling for the nylon. He's in for the touchdown. What a start for Ethan Gomez. 6 of 6 through the air. It's a 10-yard pitch and catch from Gomez to Ruiz. And the Buffaloes lead it 13-7 with 5:17 to go here in the opening half. That is Mario Ruiz's first catch of the season. Bunch of misdirection. They sent Gomez in motion, moved him underneath Carl along the far sideline, and got to the pylon. Snap, the hold, the kick, and the PAT from Eddie Rodriguez is good.
Extra point by Eddie Rodriguez is good. Well,
there is a flag down at the 5-yard line. Someone might have jumped early. As it stands, it's a 9-play drive that went 40 yards for Garden City and took roughly 4:45 off the clock. Buffaloes have made their way off the field. We've still yet to confirm what the penalty is. The Buffaloes believe it's an offsides penalty, as one of the linemen will make his way over to Brian Hill. Regardless, as it stands, Garden City's got the lead. Here comes the call from the head official. It's a personal foul penalty, which will be the count, and the PAT is good. So the Buffaloes march down the field on the 9-play scoring drive. 5:17 to go in the opening half. Garden City 14, Hayes 7 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
At Lewis Automotive Group, we take pride in putting together the best team. We have a knowledgeable sales staff to best represent us, and we recruit and train the best technicians available to make sure you are taken care of after the sale. So come see us and join our winning team.
I'm Ochak Baji.
I am Christian Brown.
I'm David McCormick.
Come join the winning Lewis team like I did.
Buy local, buy for less, buy Lewis.
Ten-yard pitch and catch. Ethan Gomez finds Mario Ruiz for his 6th total touchdown of the season. And Garden City has their first lead of the night, 14-7, here at Lewis Field in Hayes. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. That last play, a 9-play, 40-yard scoring drive, taking 4:47 off the clock here in this second quarter as the Buffaloes take advantage of the forced fumble. Eddie Rodriguez strides forward and sends this one away towards the left end zone. The Indians will let this one bounce all the way back into the end zone for a touchback.
Touchback.
The Indians will start inside their own 25-yard line. 20-yard line. So looking at the offense so far for Hayes, they were able to execute on that big-time punt return by Jarrett Purdy, who returned to the 15-yard line. They then had a 6-play, 15-yard scoring drive after that, but their quarterback, Dean Carter Graham, is 0-for-3 through the air tonight. And Zane Diego, who is their leading rusher, just fumbled on his last carry. So we'll see how head coach Tony Brown wants to ignite this offense here. 5:17 to go in the opening half. First down and 10 from the 20. The snap leads to Diego right up the middle. He gets the handoff from Graham and moves his way forward for about 2 yards. He is stood up by a couple of white jerseys, including David Holgate.
He's tackled number 25.
David Holgate is great this game this year. 7 tackles, 4 solos, and it was part of a great sophomore season, where he grew into a key part of this defensive line with 64 total tackles and 5 tackles for loss. Gain of 2 for Diego, whose longest run all night was for 11. That was his 7th carry of the ball game. 2 wide receivers out to the far side. There's one there in the pistol on the 2nd and 8. Graham looking to throw. Has plenty of time in the pocket. Fires over the middle. The pass is complete to the 34-yard line. The first down for Hayes. Right through a seam. It's Brandon Mokel who makes the first catch of the night for the Indians. 4th string wide receiver on this team. And the Indians move it 12 yards down the field on Graham's first completion. He's now 1-for-4 with that 12-yard pitch and catch on the in route over the middle. First down and 10, handoff is to Diego, trying to find a seam through that left side of the offensive line. He'll move his way for about 3.
Zane Diego.
As Garden City's defensive line is
the strength of their season. Eddie Rodriguez at number 62, Tony Heenan.
Great against the run, they really limited
3 yards on the play, second
Wichita West last week, who ran for a net total of 14 yards in that opening half. Under 4 minutes to go here at Lewis Field for Hayes. The Indians trail it 14-7. They've got the ball at the 42-yard line here, 2nd down and 7. This is set, two wide receivers to the near. Graham looking to throw, fires one toward the near sideline, caught by Cano. And he'll get to the 14-yard line. It'll make it third down and two. So gain of 6-4, Cano, his second catch of the night. Catcher tonight, fourth in the whack with 13 total receptions on the season. Leading Hayes in week one, scoring his first touchdown in that overtime win against Junction City. It'll be a third down and two for the Indians at their own 42-yard line. They've got to get it to the 44-yard line to move to six. Two wide receivers to the far sideline. Handoff is to Diego, who's moving towards the far sideline. Got the first down, past the 45-yard line, and taken down at the 47. No Malik Baugh, no Ian McGuire tonight, and Diego has taken all of the carries. He needed two, and I believe he got about five. So first down for Hayes. That was the seventh carry of the night for Diego. We will have all the halftime stats coming up on the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show. Garden City leads it 14-7, 14 unanswered for the Buffaloes on a pair of Mario Ruiz touchdowns. One on the ground, one through the air. 3:15 here to go in the opening half. First and 10 for the Indians at their own 46. Handoff is to Viegra straight up the middle. He will move his way for about one, maybe two. He stood up the line of scrimmage and just kept moving through the tackle of Sebastian Lopez. Lopez, who also was very good in this game last week, had four tackles and a tackle for a loss in what was a 30-26 win for Hayes back at Buffalo Stadium. It was the Indians' only WAC win of the season. They finished last year 1-3 in WAC play, but finished the year 10-3 on the season, losing in the 5A sub-states last year. Say no gain here. Second down. Grant looking to throw off play action. Moving on the near sideline. Fires one deep over the middle of the field into triple coverage. Tipped up and incomplete. Braden Dibble knocked it up into the air. It was a long ball intended for Moko. It bounces to the ground and quickly third down and long. Very reminiscent to the 43-yard pass that Garden City had from Gomez to Sneath, where it was into triple coverage. Sun was trying to track it down. Dibble jumped up and just knocked it away. Played safe round and sorry. But fortunate, because he almost could have tipped that one to the wide receiver, who would have had green grass and a touchdown. But regardless, third down and 10 here for the Indians. They're on the 46-yard line. They've got to get up to the Garden City 44 to move the chains. And now whistles blow and a timeout called here by Hayes. Play clock winding down. We'll take a break with them. 30-second timeout. 2:25 to go in the opening half. It's Garden City 14 and Hayes 7 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
There's some reason we're all here. To create an amazing experience for each life we touch. If we look closely, we might just see there's something about you amazing people. These amazing drinks served this amazingly fast. There's just something about Scooter's Coffee.
Welcome back to Lewis Field. Hayes using the first of their three timeouts here with 2:25 to go in the opening half. Garden City leads it 14-7 on a one-yard rushing touchdown by Mario Ruiz and a 10-yard pitch and catch from Ethan Gomez to the aforementioned Ruiz. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Thank you so much for tuning in. We've got a couple of those scores to give you. The Sanitown scoreboard update is brought to you by Crazy House, the Boot King of Kansas. Great Bend looking for their second win of the season. Leads 21-0 against Wichita Southeast. And Holcomb trying to move to 3-1 on the season. Leads Goodland 7-0 at the end of one. A's will line up at their own 46-yard line here on third down and 10. The quarterback, Carter Graham, who is 2 of 6 through the air for 18 yards. No touchdowns, no picks. Two wide receivers to the far side, one in the near in the pistol set. Graham's looking to throw. Five-man rush from Garden City. Graham fires over the middle, in and out of the hands of Dibble, and incomplete. Almost intercepted by the Buffaloes, 3-safety. But after a couple of first downs, the Buffaloes will likely get the Indians off the field. It's blocked shots with 2:19 to go here in the opening half. So back-to-back PBUs for Braden Dibble, who entered this week with 24 tackles and 3 tackles for loss on the season, after he had 6 in a tackle for loss last week. So Graham, who could line up as the punter, will take a couple steps back. He's the quarterback who also punts here for this Hayes team. Klaus Sands doesn't receive the snap. Got seven snap, takes the snap and sends this one away. Nobody back deep to return for Garden City. It bounces at the 17-yard line, rolling towards the end zone, takes a friendly Hayes bounce, and will be stopped at about the 9-yard line. So the second time that Graham has pinned Garden City back in their own territory, yet went all the way back to the 2-yard line earlier.
Now inside the 10 at the 9-yard line.
And now Garden City will take back over. I think about 91 yards if they want to stretch this lead. But it might not be impossible for Ethan Gomez, who has started this game as sharp as any quarterback has looked in Kansas so far this week. Got that 43-yard completion to Braden Sneed. Had a 20-yard completion on third down. Gomez is 6-for-6. His last completion, a 10-yard touchdown pass to the running back, Mario Ruiz. Buffaloes are out of timeouts. They've already spent all three here with 2:07 to go. Sun is now completely set here in Ellis County. A beautiful night for football at Ellis Field. Buffaloes come out in a single back set. One wide receiver to the near side. The handoff is to Mario Ruiz, pushing along the right side of the offensive line. Gets maybe two as the clock winds up 2 minutes to go here in the opening half. We'll see how Brian Hill wants to play it. Garden City's got the lead. They've looked better and better as this half has gone on. They've taken the lead after that forced fumble. They say 2 yards for Mario Ruiz, who's coming back after missing last week's game with an ankle injury. That was his 14th carry already tonight. Clock still winding here, 1:40 to go in the second quarter. Say no gain on the play. As Gomez rushes back from the sideline, we got the play call from Brian Hill. 1:30 to go in the opening half. Down to 8 seconds on the play clock. Garden City comes out in the flex bone set. They bunch the wide receiver, Sneaking Sunt in. Allen in motion. The handoff is to Ruiz, who finds a seam along the right sideline and gets to
about
13-yard line. Will make it third down and long. We'll see if the Indians might want to use a timeout here, and they will. So they stop the clock with 1:10 to go. It'll be a third down and probably around six here for Garden City when we come back here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Timeout Indians, their second timeout.
And the bar as high as it goes. When it comes to three.
KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Big start from Garden City. Despite trailing 7-0, they found their way down the field on a 9-play, 69-yard touchdown drive, and they took advantage off of the forced fumble, the first turnover of the night by either team, to march it down the field 40 yards to take the lead on a Gomez touchdown pass to Mario Ruiz. Fifth touchdown pass of the season for Gomez, who is now into third in the WAC in passing touchdowns. So here comes a 3rd and 6 here for Garden City. They've already got the lead. Hayes has one more timeout to use if they want to try and stop the clock and get the ball back. Garden City can't pick up the first. One wide receiver to each side in the flexbone offensive set here for Garden City. Villalobos goes in motion. A man jumped on the far side of the offensive line. This should be an offside. Dalton Myers, the edge rusher, was trying to get into the offensive line. Villalobos kind of went on a stunt motion.
Offside against the Indians.
So another pre-snap penalty against Hayes. That's their
first down,
fourth pre-snap penalty of the night. And because it was 3rd and 5, they're going to give Garden City the first down. That's a penalty you just can't take. The Jumbotron here at Lewis Field said 3rd down and 6. From my angle, from along the far side of the line, that's what it looked like it was. But it was 3rd down and 5, so the Garden City Buffaloes have the first down at their own 20-yard line. 1st and 10, 1:10 to go in the opening half. Gomez the snap, hands it off to Ruiz, who finds a crease and gets about 2 yards along the right side of the field. Ruiz has gotten the work of the rushing yards tonight. That is his 16th carry already, but it's Villalobos who's got the most positive yards tonight. Ruiz does have the rushing touchdown. He pounded it in from the goal line. Clock winds
45 seconds
to go here in the opening half. The Buffaloes have come from behind to lead here at Hayes. Plenty of fans traveling to support along the far sideline here at Lewis Field. 30 seconds to go, could be the last play of the half. Single back set, three wide receivers out to the right side to bunch. Gomez takes the snap, hands it off to Ruiz, and he'll get one, maybe two. And the clock lasts 20 seconds. The Sooners wants to stop it. They've got one timeout to use. Garden City's coming to the offensive line. They got 10 seconds to try and get a play in. Garden City is content to let the first half wind down. So the Buffaloes, despite trailing 7-0 in the first quarter, have come from behind to lead 14-7 to Deering Hayes. When we come back, we will give you all the stats and more for the first half of the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show. Garden City 14, Hayes 7 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Performances for you. We have the Hayside Cheerleaders and kindergarten to fifth grade students entertaining you, and then we have the pride of Northwest Kansas, the Hayside Marching Band, performing also at halftime.
I encourage you to browse their online inventory, schedule a test drive, and investigate financing options. You can also request more information about a vehicle using the online form. For more information, go online to buylewis.com, where you always get it for less.
At Western State Bank, we're excited to announce Western Rewards, a new program giving personal debit card users the chance to earn cash back, merchandise, and more, with no maximum on points or cash back. Plus, we're giving all of our personal debit card holders 500 bonus points. Not yet banking with us? Open an account online or in person this month, and you too can earn the 500-point customer bonus. Visit WSBKS.com for Western Rewards details. Western State Bank, member FDIC.
Must play bonus play by September 30th. Restrictions apply. Visit their website to learn more.
Austin Pools of Hot Springs Tubs in Dodge City of Garden City can offer you a great deal on the Hot Spring NXT and the Hot Spring Spa. Purchase a new High Life or High Life NXT Hot Spring Spa from Austin Pool and enjoy knowing that you're doing business locally, which gives you the opportunity to keep your business right here in Southwest Kansas.
All right, folks, we got a special treat for you, the Hayside Cheerleaders. We'll be performing a routine with kindergarten through fifth grade students. This will be a great one, folks. Good luck, ladies and gentlemen. Your music is on.
Football season is here, and Airstrands has you covered with steaks, burgers, and hot dogs.
Welcome back to Lewis Field. The Garden City Buffaloes are in front at the halftime break with 14 unanswered to lead this one 14-7. With that, we welcome you into the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show. Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant is your spot for great specials and a great time, serving breakfast all day long and great smoked barbecue located on Taylor Avenue in Garden City. That's Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. In what got started out as a very slow game with three straight three and outs, Hayes got the scoring start in the first quarter after a big-time 35-yard punt return.
by sophomore wide receiver Jared Purdy, who faked the pitch to an oncoming Hayes inmate in Cooper Lindenmeyer and ran up the near sideline, taken down by the punter in Eddie Rodriguez, which sent Hayes up inside the Lewis Automotive Group red zone. The Indians marched downfield 6 plays, 15-yard touchdown drive, punched in on a 4-yard touchdown rush by backup running back Zane Viegra. Now it's a losing story for Hayes tonight, the offensive running back position. Malik Bob, who is the leading rusher in the WAC, is out tonight due to a game-time decision. He hadn't been practicing the pads this week. He was kept out of this game despite practicing earlier on. Ian McGuire, who was the fill-in running back last week,
Trip Majors, is your band ready?
Got injured earlier this week and was ruled out earlier today. So it was going to be interesting to see what the Buffaloes had to defend against on the ground. They go to Viegra, the 6-foot sophomore, who plays the backup quarterback on this team. And he has done a great job running the ball on the ground. He's got 7 carries for 33 yards and that touchdown. Garden City responded immediately. That's been something that Garden City has done so well this season, is respond to adversity. And Ethan Gomez, who had a dynamite first half, got a little bit lucky on his first completion of the day as he had a pass downfield tipped and straight into the on-waiting arm of Braden Sneed. He made the catch at the 36-yard line of Hayes for a gain of 43, which stands as the longest play of the half for either team. Garden City, after that, were able to punch it down the field on a couple of rushing plays, and Mario Ruiz was able to find the end zone from 1 yard out. So Garden City with a 9-play, 69-yard touchdown drive at the end of the first quarter to tie the ball game at 1. Mario Ruiz, who missed last week due to an injury, his 4th rushing touchdown of the season, now tied with Liberals Brooks Kaplan for the lead in rushing touchdowns in the WAC. Right after that, the Buffaloes defense might have been a little frustrated after giving up their first half touchdown, all season long. They force a fumble against the running back in Viegra, punched out at the 40-yard line, and the Buffaloes got great field position and moved downfield 9 plays, 40 yards. As on third down, Ethan Gomez did a very good job on a 3rd and 17 to find Braden Sneed for a 20-yard completion, and a couple of plays later on a 3rd down and 10, he found a wide-open Mario Ruiz out of the backfield for a 10-yard pitch and catch. Mario Ruiz's first ever receiving touchdown, and as mentioned, his 5th total touchdown of the season, with Garden City ahead 14-7. That was the end of the turnover in the game between both teams. They each got a chance to punch for the end of the first half. Hayes got a couple of first downs, but were forced to punt after a 3rd down and 10 completion, and Garden City just winded out the clock from there. So now let's bring you into some of the individual stats. We'll start with the Garden City Buffaloes. How about this first half for Ethan Gomez? Someone who came in tonight with just 17 passing attempts all season, goes 6-for-6 in the opening half for 110 yards, 1 touchdown, and no interceptions. On the other side for Hayes, they're struggling to move the ball down the field, as Carter Graham is 2-for-6 through the air for 18 yards. Completion of 12 yards and 6 yards. Zane Viegra also had a pass earlier on in that half, which is a 1-yard pitch to Johnny Cano on one of those jet motion sweeps. On the rushing side for Garden City, Mario Ruiz had 17 carries and is roughly around 20 yards right now, but he does have that 1 touchdown. Ethan Allen's had 4 carries so far, like 2 of which going backwards and 2 of which going for 5. His net total is 2 yards, and Michael Villalobos has 8 yards on 3 carries so far. Through the air, Braden Sneed is having a great night. He's got 2 catches for 63 yards to go over 100 yards on the season. He entered tonight with 2 receptions for 61 yards and a pair of touchdowns. Ethan Allen has a 17-yard catch, which set up the Buffaloes' touchdown on a 17-yard wheel route. Michael Villalobos with 11 yards through the air, and Emilio Zunt and Mario Ruiz each with 10 yards through the air. Ruiz, of course, with that receiving touchdown. On the other side for the Hayes Indians, we mentioned Carter Graham's stat line. He is 2-for-6 for 18 yards, no touchdowns, no interceptions. Zane Viegra 1-for-1 through the air for 1 yard, no touchdown, no picks. Through the ground game, it's been all Viegra, who's got all 7 carries in that first half for Hayes, for 33 yards, 1 touchdown, which we mentioned, of 4 yards, and 1 fumble in this game. Through the air, Braden Boko leads the way for the Indians, 1 catch for 12 yards, and Johnny Cano, 2 catches for 7 yards tonight. 1 forced turnover to be in this game by the Garden City defense. The Buffalo's offense has yet to turn the ball. Hayes has taken the bulk of the penalties in this game. They have taken 6 penalties so far. Garden City has just taken 1. When we come back here on the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show, we'll give you scores around the rest of the state, including some big-time games in the WAC. Buffalo's leading 14-7 for now here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. To Lewis Field here on the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show. The Garden City Buffaloes lead 14-7 against Hayes. That's the score here at Lewis Field. Let's give you some scores around the rest of Kansas. The out-of-town scoreboard is brought to you by Crazy House. Crazy House reminds you they are the boot king of Kansas. In the WAC Conference, Dodge City and Liberal tied up at 7 at the break over in Dodge City. Redskins starting the season 3-0 for the first time since 2003. Dodge City has started the year off 2-1. That one is at the break. Scott City, after they lost 6-0 last week, after scoring 50 in the week prior, leads 14-0 over undefeated TMP, the Beavers, with a pair of first-half touchdowns to lead in that one. And the Hugoton Longhorns lead Colby 14-6 at the break. Hugoton, after losing to Liberal in week one, is trying to win their third game in a row. Before we step aside for the final time here on the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show, let's give you a look at the standings in the WAC coming into tonight. Hayes led the way after they got that week two win in conference against Great Bend, winning 21-27. Hayes stands top of the conference for now at 2-1 on the season, 1-0 in conference play. Liberal, Dodge City, and Garden City enter tonight without a conference game. The Redskins in second with a 3-0 record. Dodge City, Garden City each 2-1 on the season, 0-0 in conference play. And Great Bend 0-1 in WAC play after the loss, and 1-2 overall. This second half is going to be a big one. Garden City's talked about it all week long. They're trying to find that killer instinct to come out of this second half and show some urgency. Last week, the Buffaloes were shut out in the third quarter. Despite winning that game 35-6, in their first road game of the season, they led 19-6 in the half, wind up surrendering that and losing 20-19. So keeping this second half is paramount for the Buffaloes as we're about 2.5 minutes away from second half kickoff. It'll be Hayes who will get the ball to start the second half. But for now, Garden City leads at 14-7 here on the Timeout Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Hey, don't let this sound good.
Thanks to the Temple's parents.
community members who will demonstrate to our more that Red Band Hockey.
Through the Delights, the Crepe House is a proud Garden City High School sports sponsor, and they invite you to stop by after the game to try their homemade delicious crepe.
So much for tuning in to the Time Out Sports Bar and Restaurant Halftime Show. Time Out Sports Bar and Restaurant reminds you they are the great spot for specials and a great time serving breakfast all day, great smoked barbecue, located on Taylor Avenue in Garden City. That's Time Out Sports Bar and Restaurant. Well, it's a half that the Buffaloes didn't get off to the best start, and they went 3-and-out on their opening two possessions after Hayes deferred to the second half. So the Indians will start the second half with the ball, but Garden City did a great job to close that half. You have to give full credit to the passing offense because Ethan Gomez going into tonight's game, only 17 attempts through the air in the first 3 weeks of the season. You do your math, and that's less than 6 yards an attempt for every ball game so far. But in that first half, 6 passing attempts, he completes all 6 for a long of 43, 1 passing touchdown, no interceptions, 111 yards through the air. Braden Steve led the way for the Buffaloes in that opening 24 minutes with 63 yards. And it's funny when I talk about Braden Steve, normally you think of wide receivers, they're very loud down, they want the ball, they want to have big plays to run through them. But when I talked to Brian Hill off Buff Talk earlier this week, he said you wouldn't know he's around, he hardly speaks, but he's improved so much and he's earned the respect of his teammates because he takes care of his business day in, day out. He said he proved that he can be a deep threat for us, and in our offense, we don't need first downs, we need touchdowns. Well, he came into this game with 2 touchdowns on 2 receptions, but both of his receptions tonight have been as big as touchdowns receptions. He got the Garden City offense moving after that pair of 3-and-outs with that 43-yard catch, and then he converted a 3rd-and-17 with a 20-yard reception by Ethan Gomez. Surprisingly, these two teams, despite being some of the better teams in the conference in rushing, they came in 2nd and 3rd, respectively, in rushing yards in the WAC, have not been able to do too much on the ground. That's all being due to an injury on the Hayes side of things. Malik Baugh, who is the leading rusher in the entire WAC, is out tonight. His replacement is Zane Viegra. 7 carries for 33 yards in that opening half, 1 touchdown and 1 fumble. Garden City's leading rusher was Mario Ruiz. who had 17 carries for 20 yards. The important thing for Ruiz, he had that touchdown on the ground, and he had a touchdown through the air. His first career receiving touchdown on a 10-yard pitch and catch. And Ethan Gomez. Garden City will get the second half underway, going from left to right across your radio now, kicking away to the Indians, who have two players deep. Their last kickoff return was a short kick by Rodriguez, returned by one of the upbacks. Hayes actually fumbled the kickoff. They got back on top of it, but two plays later, the Indians would fumble on the 11-yard rush. That was the only turnover in the first half. The Buffaloes got seven off it on the touchdown by Luis from Gomez, and that is where we stand. 24 minutes down, 24 minutes to go. Here from Lewis Field, thank you so much for tuning in on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Eddie Rodriguez, 2-for-2 on a pair of VATs. We'll send this one away left to right across the radio now. Returning deep for the Indians are Johnny Cannell and Jarek Burton. Rodriguez sends this one away with his left foot towards the far side. It'll take a bounce at the 20. This one could roll out of bounds. And I believe that's Garden City football. Because on the kickoff, Hayes had to play. If Garden City recovered that one, I think it's out of bounds. It did roll out of bounds, excuse me. Garden City did fall, and the ball had rolled out of bounds. So as it stands, I believe the Indians should start at 35-yard line. We're waiting on the call. Garden City only committed one penalty in that entire first half, but this one is going to go against them as Rodriguez's kick goes out of bounds. And the Indians will start off at the 35-yard line. He's got some very good field position in that opening half. Their first two drives started at midfield and the Garden City 15. They come out with four wide receivers each side. The quarterback, Carter Graham, 2-for-6 so far for 18 yards. No touchdowns, no picks. Got a tight end along the right side of the offensive line and two wide receivers coached out to each side. Graham on a quarterback power through the right side. Might have gotten one, maybe two, before he's wrapped up by Eddie Rodriguez. Who has been at the heart of everything, this middle linebacker for the Buffaloes, had 10 tackles in this game last season, entered tonight with 23 tackles on the season, three tackles for loss, and a forced fumble. Zane Grieger will motion out, play call from the right sideline. They say gain of two on that rush to open up the second half. First rushing attempt all day for Carter Graham, who has not rushed that much this season. Second down and 8 for the Indians. They go into a pistol set. Two wide receivers to the near side. It's a screen pass to the near sideline. Caught by Cano. Past the 40-yard line. And taken down just before the first down yardage. So I think he's about 1 to 2 yards short. Emilio Sunt on the tackle for Garden City. Third catch of the game for Cano. He had 7 yards on a pair of catches in the first half. It's a gain of 6. It'll be 3rd down and 1 here for Hayes. Have to get it to their own 45-yard line to move the chains. Pistol set, two wide receivers to the far side. They go on a pass to the near side, caught for the first down. That's Brandon Moku, who led the Indians in receiving yards in the first half. They needed one, and I believe they got 3 as they downed the ball at the 47-yard line. So Moku up to 15 yards on the game.
3 yards, gain on the play, good for the Indians.
As Graham completes his first pass of the second half. Two wide receivers out to the far side, one to the near. Pistol set here with 10:45. Handoff goes to Diego. His first carry of the half gets away from Rodriguez and goes down after a gain of 2. Diego carried for 33 yards on 9 carries in the opening half. As mentioned, that 4-yard touchdown. First touchdown of his career for the sophomore who played for the Indians varsity team, or excuse me, freshman team last season, now playing for varsity. Indians at 2-1 on the season, as is Garden City. They'll go 3 wide receivers out to the far sideline here on 2nd and 8, ball down at midfield. Pistol set. Diego, the lone running back, standing right behind Graham. He was 1-for-1 through the air in this second half. 8 seconds to get the playoff. Now 6 seconds. Graham, waiting the snap, takes the snap. Hands it off to the near side for Diego, who cuts past midfield and goes down in a sea of white jerseys at about the 47-yard line for a gain of 3. As we mentioned, no Malik Bond tonight, no Ian McGuire for this Indians team, which came into tonight third in the WAC with 573 rushing yards on the season. So after that short yardage run, it's going to be 3rd down and 5 here for Hayes at the Garden City 47-yard line. Snap to Graham, looking to throw, fires one near side, complete to the 40-yard line. That's an Indian first down.
Jarek Purdy makes his first catch of the night. Came into tonight fourth in the WAC in receiving yards.
8 yards.
And on 5 yards, they say he gets 8 for the first down for the Indians. This ball about 39-yard line. He ran a little out route along the near sideline, just 4 steps out, and then moves out to the left. Just a little thing so far getting done here for Graham through the air. He sends a man in motion on first and 10 and gives it off to Vieger, who finds a hole on the right side of the offensive line and carries his way to about the 37-yard line for a 2-yard gain. So Graham, who was just 2 for 6 in that opening half, has started off 2 for 2. 2 short-yardage plays, but 2 of them helped the Indians move the sticks. Right now, a really nice drive here by Hayes, their longest drive of the game. As their only scoring drive in that opening half went 6 plays for 15 yards. Gain of 2 on that run by Vieira, so now 2nd down and 8 at the Garden City 37-yard line. Hayes trailing at 14-7, 8:51 here to go in the third quarter. Graham looking to throw out to the near sideline for Kano, who stood up at the 39-yard line. Great tackle by Emilio Zunt, who read the screen the entire way, and he will make it 3rd and long.
Emilio Zunt, I'm a stop.
Zunt, who had 2 tackles in this game last season as a junior, 2 of his 5 tackles, someone who wears that Garden City number 5 for 3 different sports, including the starting point guard on the varsity basketball team, and also plays baseball. So Kano with his 4th catch of the night, but he's barely past 10 yards. 3rd down and 9 here for Hayes. They take the snap, hand it off to Vieira, who's trying to counter to the outside, and Garden City wraps him up. Eddie Rodriguez standing right over the running back. They'll say loss on the play and make it 4th down and 11. Eddie Rodriguez is such a great linebacker. The way he flies from the middle of the field out towards that left side as Hayes were trying to set up a 4th and short on the run. Instead, it's going to be 4th and long. 4th and 10. They down at the 39 of Garden City. Graham takes 2 steps back. He might punt this one. He's a quarterback who also operates as a punter, very similar to what the Garden City Bronkbusters do with Cody Kirk. Takes the snap and will send this one away, takes 1 step forward. Garden City's got nobody back deep to return, as this one takes a Hayes bounce at the 4-yard line and will nestle back to the 5. So the 3rd time tonight that Carter Graham has pinned Garden City inside their own 10-yard line. He got 1 down to the 2, 1 down to the 9, and the Buffaloes will start the 2nd half with a 7-point lead. Having to go 95 yards down the field if they want to make it a 2-touchdown game. But with the way that Ethan Gomez has played tonight, nothing is impossible for this Garden City offense. Gomez, after only averaging about 80 yards through the air in his first 3 games, has thrown for 111 on a perfect 6 of 6 tonight. We'll see how Garden City moves the offense here in this 2nd half as they come out with the ball down their own 3-yard line. 1st and 10 from the 4, excuse me. They go single back, 3 wide receivers bunched up to the far sideline. It's a pitch to Mario Ruiz out to the far sideline, past the 5-yard line, past the 10, and he gets his way up for 9. That's Ruiz's biggest carry of the night. His longest run in the first half was only 4 yards, but he did have a touchdown. As Ruiz now up to 5 total touchdowns on the season, 4 on the ground and 1 through the air, despite missing a game. They're actually going to give him 10 yards, and they're going to give Garden City the 1st down. So my mistake, 1st down Buffaloes on their 1st play of the 2nd half. Regardless, point still stands. Longest rush of the night for Mario Ruiz, who entered tonight with 149 yards on the ground against Wichita Heights in the 1st road game of the season, had a pair of touchdowns. 1st and 10, they pitch out to the far sideline, running along the far sideline, past the 15 to the 20 is Michael Villalobos, before he's shoved out of bounds by a couple of yellow uniforms. Villalobos only with 3 carries in that entire first half. He carries for 7, maybe 8. They'll say 5 on the play. He stepped out of bounds with his back foot, excuse me, and the ball kept moving. So 5-yard gain for Michael Villalobos, the junior who came in tonight with 170 yards all-purpose and a touchdown, which came in week 2 in that 70-15 win over Wichita North. They go 2 wide receivers out to the far sideline, 1 to the near here, 2nd down and 4. Handoff goes straight up the middle to Ruiz, who's trying to push his way through the pile. They'll call him down on forward contact after a gain of 3.
So two carries and 13 yards for Ruiz here in the second half. That's going to bring up a third down and one here for the Buffalo. 6:30 to go here in the third quarter. Garden City leading it 14-7 over Hayes.
It's third down.
Garden City was very good on third downs in that opening half. A couple of completions through the air. When they got to this situation, third and short, they would most commonly go to Mario Ruiz, who again didn't have the most rushing yards in that first half, but was just able to move the pile. He lines up as the setback right now, flex bone formation, one wide receiver to each side for Gomez, who gives it up to Ruiz up the middle, trying to get a push. It's going to be close to see if he got it. He moved to the left side of the offensive line. Hayes anticipated it. And as it stands, it's going to be fourth and inches. Well, the Buffaloes are back deep in their own territory. They've got to get it to the 24-yard line here on fourth down and inches. As the play clock is down to 20 seconds, and they will go for it as Ethan Gomez gets the play call in. Well, they don't need all that much, but if they're unable to convert here, they're going to give Hayes great field position with a chance to potentially tie this ball game. Fourth and one. Allen goes in motion, now fakes the motion, moves out to the far side. There's only 3 seconds to snap. And Garden City were trying to get Hayes off sides. They will call a timeout and likely send this one away. We'll take a break with them. 30-second timeout, 5:17 to go in the third quarter. Still no score in this second half for the Buffaloes, leading at 14-7 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
The mission of the Casnetti Group is to make your insurance experience convenient, simple, and affordable. They would meet a welcoming staff and people that really care about them and want to, you know, help them with their needs, whatever that might be. What is most satisfying about what I do is our clients. Bottom line, I love just watching our clients grow and get to be part of their life.
Welcome back to Lewis Field here in Hayes. Garden City leads it 14-7. They have a fourth and inches coming up on their own 23-yard line. They were trying to draw Hayes offside before head coach Brian Hill used the first of his three timeouts here in the second half. Neither team has yet to return to the field yet. We'll see if Garden City still lets to go for it here. And Ethan Gomez is leading the offense back onto the field. So this is a big decision right now. New Garden City, you've got the momentum in this game. But Brian Hill mentioned earlier on this week, he wanted this killer instinct to come out at the start of the second half. And they're going to go for it here. Fourth and one. It's a quarterback sneak for Ethan Gomez, trying to find the push. Hayes doesn't think he has it. Waiting for the signal. Defensive coordinator Kip Keeley is fired up along the near sideline. And Hayes has stuffed Garden City short. Really risky decision right there for Brian Hill, going for it on fourth and one on his own 23-yard line. They go with the QB sneak up the middle, and the defensive front of Hayes wins the battle. And the Indians will take over at the Garden City 23-yard line. First carry of the night for Gomez, and it goes for naught. So now Hayes will set up. Down 14-7, Garden City 23-yard line in great field position here. First down and 10. Pistol set for Carter Graham. He's got two wide receivers along the near sideline. Takes the snap, hands it off to Viegra on his own. Uses a big stiff arm and gets about 1 yard. He stuffed Colden Plankenhorn aside, but he had nowhere else to go as Theo Holge makes the tackle. 1 yard gain for the running back, who had four carries on that first drive where Hayes got a couple first downs but were forced to punt. It's a loss of one on the play. Second down and 11. The Garden City 24. Two wide receivers in the near side, one in the far. Graham looking to throw. Steps up and fires towards the near side. End zone! Broken up, but caught for the touchdown! It's Moku who makes the catch on the deflection. Dibble got a hand to it. It pops right up into the hands of the junior. And with 4:29 here to go in the third quarter, Hayes an extra point away from tying it. It's Garden City 14 and Hayes 13. First catch all season for Moku goes 24 yards for a score as Graham has come out 3 for 3 here in this second half. And he finds his third passing touchdown of the season. Zimmerman on for the PAT to try and tie this ball game up. Snap, hold, kick, is a low one, but this kick is good. Garden City goes forward on their own 23-yard line. Two plays later, the Indians with their biggest play of the game to tie this one up. 4:29 to go in the third quarter. It's Garden City 14 and Hayes 14 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
When was the last time your family had their best day ever? Come to Garden City, Kansas, where you can slide, splash, and play this summer. The all-new Garden Rapids at the Big Pool. Thrills and chills for the whole family. Parrot Cove Indoor Water Park, where there's something for everyone. No matter what the weather, we have you covered. Garden City, Kansas has the coolest spots under the sun. Make a splash.
Two-play, 24-yard touchdown drive for the Hayes Indians on a 24-yard pitch and catch from Carter Graham to junior Braden Mokel. Cal Friedman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Tie ball game in the WAC opener for the Buffaloes as the Hayes Indians get that fourth down stop and execute two plays later. Third touchdown pass of the season for Carter Graham, who has come out firing here in this second half. And now it's the Buffaloes who are going to need a big response as the momentum has swung back the way of Hayes. It's a great crowd tonight here at Lewis Field, the home of the Fort Hayes State Tigers. The near side along my side is packed with the maroon and gold of the Hayes Indians. Plenty of Buffaloes fans have made the trip east from Garden City, packing along the far bleachers in their brown shirts. And Garden City trying to find an answer to these slow starts to their second halves. Go for it on a fourth down and one at their 23. They elect to go with a quarterback sneak with Ethan Gomez. Give credit to the defensive line of Hayes for getting that push on the offensive line and making sure that Garden City couldn't pick up the first down. Zimmerman steps up and sends this one away. Garden City going from left to right across your radio now. Allen makes the catch and will return this one from the 2-yard line. Moving out towards the far sideline. Stood up at the 10. Garden City special teams did not set up well there. Four yellow jerseys came in and swarmed the Garden City returner, and it's poor field position here for the Buffaloes. This is a Garden City team that had returned kicks 86 yards and 87 yards, respectively, in each of the last 2 weeks. Brian Hill said it earlier today that he loved the way that it could strike fear into opponents, but that time, nothing going for Allen, who had to return it as it was short of the end zone. Trying to move out to the far sideline, then got cut in the middle of the field trying to find his blocks. There was nothing there. So Garden City takes over at the 10-yard line here. First down and 10 in a 14-14 ball game. Ethan Gomez fakes the pitch on play action along the near sideline. Throws, intercepted at the 30-yard line. The safety, Johnny Rigler, comes up with it. It's his second interception of the season. And back to that plays, this Indians defense has gotten Garden City off the field. Third interception thrown this season by Gomez. First incompletion all night for him. And man, has this game swung for Hayes, who will now take over at the 32-yard line, tied up at 14, with an opportunity to take their first lead since the first quarter. Quarterback Carter Graham, 3 for 3 in this half at the moment. For 35 yards and a touchdown pass. Three wide receivers to the near side. He sends one in motion. He gives it off on a pitch to Johnny Cano running along the far sideline. Might have gotten back to the line of scrimmage. I think he lost one. Fifth reception already for Cano tonight, who came in leading the Indians with 13 receptions on the season. They'll say loss of one. So now this Garden City defense, which came into tonight first in the WAC in yards given up and points given up, as their backs to the wall as Hayes start off in plus territory for the second consecutive possession after the Gomez interception. Two wide receivers to the near sideline, one to the far here, second down and 11. Play action for Graham, has plenty of time in the pocket, fires one over the middle, he's got a man too high and incomplete. He was looking back Mokel's way, good coverage downfield by Evan Finch. It'll be third down and long. First incompletion thrown all half by Graham. He was going for it all to the end zone and might have led it a couple steps ahead of Mokel. who has been the go-to receiver tonight for Hayes, had 12 yards in the first half. And in the second half, two catches for 27 yards and a touchdown. Third down and 12 here for Hayes at the Garden City 34. Tie ball game at 3:28 to go in the third. Play action. Graham standing still in the pocket. Now moves out to the near sideline, has nothing open, trying to run it himself, and he's wrapped up by Carson Krause behind the line of scrimmage. Taken down back at the 35. It's Krause's third and a half sack on the season to lead the WAC.
That's the yard on the play.
So now, decision time for the Indians, as they have it fourth and 13, they'll say, at the 35-yard line. They've got to get it to the Garden City 22. Carter Graham has pinned Garden City inside the 10-yard line three times tonight as they punch in. They'll go pistol set here, fourth and 13. They need the Garden City 22. Two wide receivers to the near side. Play action for Graham. Pressure on the edge from Krause. Rolling out to the far sideline. Set by Krause. Big stop for the Buffaloes. Second sack in as many plays for Krause. And he has just become a force in this Garden City team. I talked to Justin Reich earlier this week. He said Carson is a diamond in the rough. One of the kindest humans you'll meet, and someone who has made the jump from not playing football since his freshman season, coming back as a senior, and becoming one of the key playmakers for this Buffaloes defense. Now up to 4.5 sacks on the season to lead the conference as Garden City, despite the interception, will get the ball back here at their own 37-yard line. Tie ball game at 14. Snap to Ethan Gomez, but flags fly in before the play. This one might be a false start against Garden City. It would be their second penalty of the half, and it is. So the Buffaloes only took one penalty in that entire first half. Took one on the opening kickoff of the second half on the kickoff that went out of bounds. And now trying to get this third drive of the second half started, they'll go backwards before they can get the drive started. But if you're just joining us, what a second half we've seen. Garden City went for it in their own territory on a fourth down and one. Hayes stopped them and scored a touchdown two plays later. Then Garden City on their next drive intercepted on the first play. But the Buffaloes defense holds strong despite Hayes getting it at the Garden City 31. So now first down and 15, flex bone set, one wide receiver to each side, Villalobos goes in motion. Gomez, three-step drop, steps up in the pocket, fires to the far sideline, has his man, completes Ethan Allen, who steps out of bounds after a gain of 8. So that's the way to get Gomez back ticking again after he was 6-for-6 in the opening half. He finds Allen for an 8-yard completion.
Here's 13 on the play. Second down.
13 yards, excuse me, as he was second down at 15. He was 2 yards shy of the yard marker, which is why I said eight. Second catch for Allen tonight, who's up to 30 yards now. As Garden City now has it second and 2 at their own 46-yard line. Tie ball game at 4. The clock stopped at 2:28 after Allen stepped out of bounds. Second and 2. Pitch goes along to the far sideline for Villalobos, trying to get away from Kirkpatrick. And he stood up behind the line. Great tackle for a loss by the middle linebacker for this Indians team. It'll make it third down and manageable.
Kirkpatrick with the tackle.
Kirkpatrick came in tonight second in the WAC with 4 tackles for loss on the season. Also leading the conference with 35 tackles. In the WAC opener, he recorded a career-high 15 tackles in the 28-27 win over Great Bend. They say loss of 3 on that carry from Villalobos make it third down and 5 for Garden City at their own 44-yard line. Clock stopped at 2:24. Villalobos goes in motion. Gomez on a keeper, gets out of one tackle and spins his way. I believe he's got the first down. Needed 5, and I believe he's just about got that. First down, Buffaloes.
Myers with the tackle, first down, Buffaloes.
Gomez faked the handoff to Ruiz, faked the pitch to Allen, and kept it for a 6-yard gain. As Garden City at their own 49-yard line here. Clock winding to 2:09 to go in this third quarter. And man, oh man, do we have a fourth quarter in store for you. One wide receiver to each side. It's Heath to the far and Zunt to the near. Side backs are Villalobos on the right and Allen to the left. First down and 10. Villalobos goes in motion. Play action for Gomez, who is stood up for a sack. 3 Indians got into the backfield. Gomez evaded the first one but was taken down by Slade Salmons.
Clock, number 63, Slade Salmons.
third sack for this Indians defense tonight, as Garden City's offensive line just hasn't gotten the right protections on these passing downs. Loss of seven. Gotta give credit to this Hayes defense, because they gave up 42 points last week in a road match at Manhattan in a 49-7 loss. They have come out tonight with a purpose. Second down and 17 here for the Buffs. Pitch goes out to the near sideline for Mario Ruiz. He's got a big hole and gets around the original line of scrimmage. I believe Ruiz got six on the play. That was a 20th carry of the night for Mario Ruiz, who's looked a lot better here in this second half. Had a 10-yard carry to start the first drive of the half for Garden City. Picks up five there to make it third down and 12. Under a minute to go here in the third quarter. The Indians getting that game-tying touchdown as Carter Graham, on a deflection, found Braden Mokel in the back of the end zone. Third down and 12. This could be the last play of the third quarter. 5 seconds to get the playoff here for Garden City. They come out in a single back set. Pitch goes out to Ruiz along the far sideline. Gets to midfield. Nothing more, nothing less. Fourth down coming up. It was the exact same play call that Garden City went with on the second and long. It'll make it fourth down and I believe nine, as they can let this one wind to the end of the third quarter.
It's fourth down.
Garden City will come out in hunt formation here. Clock at five. Eddie Rodriguez waiting to send this one away. 3-2-1, and they do not get the punt off. So what a fourth quarter we've got in store in the WAC opener for Garden City. It's the Buffaloes 14 and the Indians 14 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
At Lewis Automotive Group, we take pride in putting together the best team. We have a knowledgeable sales staff to best represent us, and we recruit and train the best technicians available to make sure you are taken care of after the sale. So come see us and join our winning team.
I'm Ochak Baji.
I am Christian Brown.
I'm David McCormick.
Come join the winning Lewis team like I did.
Buy local, buy for less, buy Lewis.
Minutes down, 12 minutes to go from Lewis Field in Hayes. Tie ball game at 14 in the WAC opener for the Garden City Buffaloes here against the Hayes Indians. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Fourth down and nine coming up for Garden City. They bring the punt team on. Snap to Eddie Rodriguez. Sends this one away toward the far sideline. Caught on the run by one of the upbacks, who moves his way past the 30-yard line to about the 33. Good catch on the run by Cooper Lindenmeyer, the junior. He returns at about 8 yards, and that's where Hayes will set up at the 34-yard line. Well, crazy third quarter that we just saw. Garden City went for it on a fourth down and one at their own 23-yard line. Were stuffed short on a QB sneak. 2 plays later, a 24-yard touchdown catch by junior Braden Mokel from Carter Graham tied the ball game at 14. Garden City's defense held firm after that, despite an interception thrown by Ethan Gomez. They get a three and out to hold this game tied. Hayes takes over here, first down and 10 at their own 34-yard line. Hand up the middle to about the 41-yard line. Zane Vieger, who's been the leading rusher for this Indians team tonight, in replacement of Malik Baugh, gets about 7 there. Hasn't had the same success here in the second half after he had 33 yards in the opening half. That was his longest carry of the second half for 7. Second down and 3 at the 41-yard line, pistol set. Two wide receivers to the far sideline and one to the near. Here for Cooper Graham, who is 3 for 4 in this half for 32 yards and a touchdown. Takes the snap, hands it off to Vieger again, finds a seam and picks up the first down past the 45-yard line. Good job on the right side of the offensive line between the right guard Caden Bunger and right tackle Cannon Weaver, who ported a hole and made it easy for a first down pickup for the Indians. They need 3. They got 5 here as they down at the 46-yard line here. Indians with a pair of touchdowns in this game. One on the ground through Viegler and one through the air from Mokel. First and 10 from their own 46, clock at 10:50 to go. Viegler gets the ball again, moving along the right sideline, and gets maybe 2 yards at the middle of the field.
Viegler carries for the Indians.
Garden City has been stout up the middle against the run. Eddie Rodriguez with another tackle tonight. He has been busy. We've been calling his name all night long. After he had 10 tackles in this game last season, coming off 8 tackles and a tackle for a loss last week against Wichita West. Second down and 8 for the Indians. Ball down at their own 48-yard line. 2 wide receivers to the near side. Pistol set for Graham. He's looking to throw. Looking towards that near sideline. Pass is caught to the 47-yard line. The first down for Hayes into Garden City territory.
9 yard
pickup on the play as a good strike by Carter Graham to find that first down for the Indians. Birdie makes the catch. That's his second of the night. And the Indians have it into Garden City territory here. First down and 10 at the Garden City 42 and tie ball game at 14, 9:54 to go. Handoff goes up the middle to Viegra. He'll get 1, maybe 2 as 2 Buffaloes came from around the edge to make the tackle, and Blankenhorn and Krause. Krause had back-to-back sacks in that third quarter, which kept the Indians off the scoreboard and kept this game tied. But the Buffaloes offense has yet to find its rhythm here in the second half of this ballgame. They say 1 yard gain for Viegro on his 4th carry of this drive. They make it 2nd down and 9. 2 wide receivers to the near side, 1 to the far. Pistol set, Viegro the lone halfback for Graham. He takes the snap. Garden City rushes 5. He throws deep down the near sideline, too high and out of bounds, looking for Purdy.
Pass attempt for number 15, Jared Purdy.
Threw it about as far as he could have. Got that one all the way down near the 10-yard line. Hayes were thinking that Garden City was going to send a blitz and leave that right side of the field open, but good coverage by Braden Dibble. The pass was well out of bounds. Only a 2nd incompletion of the half. Make it 3rd down and 9. Garden City at 2-1 on the season here in their WAC opener. Hayes also 2-1. They are 1-0 in conference after they beat Great Bend in week 2 here at Lewis Field. 3rd down and 9 for the Indians of the Garden City 42. Take the snap, hand off to Viegra. Finds a hole between the center and the left guard and gets to about the 35-yard line. He's short of the first down, but it's going to make it 4th and short. And Hayes, well out of field goal range, is going to go for it. They come to the line quickly here, 4th down and 2 at the 35. Got to get it to the Garden City 33. 2 wide receivers out to the far sideline, 1 to the near. As Garden City actually did a great job to get back and get set as Hayes was trying to get a playoff quickly. 8:45 to go in the ball game. 4th down and 2. Graham takes the snap, hands off to Viegra along the left side, has the first down and moves his way inside the 30-yard line. Bouncing off the tackle of Finch and a first down run for the Indians. Needed 2, I think he got around 5 for Viegra, who's now north of 50 yards in this game.
That's good for the Indians. First down.
Down the ball at the 30-yard line. So gain of 5 for Viegra, who had that touchdown run in the first half. Under 8:30 to go. Here at Lewis Field and Gardens, or excuse me, between Garden City and Hayes. Tie ball game. 2 wide receivers to the near side, 1 to the far here for Graham. He's been much sharper here in the second half. 1st down and 10. Graham takes the snap. Buffaloes rush 4. He throws over the middle, has his man inside the 15-yard line, and he goes down at the 5. Pitch and catch to Johnny Kano for his biggest catch of the night. It's a 25-yard reception. It's 1st and goal, Indians. The Indians are now in the Lewis Automotive Group red zone. Lewis Automotive, your automotive home of drivers in Southwest Kansas. They'll spot him down at the 7-yard line, give or take, so a 23-yard catch for Kano. 2nd pass over 20 yards and a half for Grant. 1st and goal, come out and pistol, give it to Viegra. Trying to run up the middle, runs straight into Sebastian Lopez and is pushed backwards. So Kano, who came in tonight 4th in the WAC in receptions, but he didn't come in with the lead of receiving yards on this Indians team. Finally gets a big play downfield, a great throw by Graham right into the seam of this Garden City defense, who came out in the cover too. 2 wide receivers out to the near side, 1 to the far here, 2nd and goal for Hayes at the 8-yard line. Trying to retake the lead for the first time since the first quarter. Graham takes the snap, throws on a slant, in and out of the hands, and intercepted in the end zone. It's Ethan Allen who's got it, and he runs it out of the end zone to the 2.
His second interception of the season. It bounced in and out of the hands of Purdy, and Garden City keeps this ball game tied. Third career interception for Allen, who made the catch in the end zone. Could have just taken a knee, and Garden City could have gotten to the 20-yard line. Instead, he brought it out, and he's down inside the five. The bigger thing about that play is that Garden City gets the ball back and keeps this ball game tied. That has been the big worry for Hayes all season. That's the seventh interception thrown by Graham in four games. And it comes in the end zone. So now the Buffaloes take over inside their own 5-yard line. Looks like they've got it down to the two. The scoreboard says the four. First down and 10 regardless. Handoff goes to Ruiz. He might not have gotten out of the end zone. Still waiting on a call. The referees say he's down at the one at the moment. The Hayes sideline erupted thinking it was a safety. As it stands, I believe he's down at the one. Man, is Garden City living life on the edge here in this second half. They go for it on the fourth and one. They don't get it. Now, after the interception was run out of the end zone, they're backed up in the shadows of their own goalpost after the loss of one. Just the second negative rush of the half for Ruiz as Hayes crowds the offensive line. Seven men in the box. Second down and 11 for Garden City, their own one. Quarterback sneak for Gomez. Definitely got out of the end zone. I think he might have gotten one. At very least, no safety. So third down and long coming up. 6:10 to go in the fourth quarter. A tie ball game at 14. Ethan Allen with a huge interception to keep Hayes off the scoreboard. But Garden City, after Allen brought it out, has it third down and 10 at their own 2-yard line.
11 yards to go. It's
Ruiz was inches away from taking the safety and giving Hayes the lead again. So now third down and long. One wide receiver to each side, triple option set. And flags fly in before Gomez could take the snap. And this one is a false start against Garden City. Third penalty and a half against the Buffaloes. This is half the distance to the goal penalty. I'm not too sure how many more yards back you could go towards the goal line right now. But they will have it third down and long at their own 1-yard line. Hayes, I'm sure, is going to stack everybody into the box. You have to give huge credit to the Hayes defensive line tonight, specifically Tim McCautry and Slade Salmons in the middle. They stopped that fourth down and one. They've been excellent at stopping up the middle. Garden City's offensive line, that looks so stout so far this season, has been matched physically by Hayes. Third down and long. Quarterback sneak for Gomez, just trying to get out of his own end zone. Might have gotten one, but be fourth down. And Garden City will immediately rush the punt team on. So Ruiz almost took a safety, and back-to-back quarterback sneaks for Gomez. Net maybe 1 yard. And Hayes, after throwing that interception in the end zone, will get the ball right back. And Garden City's offense that looks so good after those 2-3 and outs to start the game is flatlined here in the second half. Eddie Rodriguez awaiting to send this one away. One man back deep is Jarek Purdy. Rodriguez had it blocked. It's in the end zone. Who's got it? Touchdown Hayes. Wyatt Kirkpatrick wheeling away in celebration. A blocked punt in the end zone. And the Indians lead 20-14 with 4:35 to go. They don't get the safety. They get in the backfield on the punt. It was a question to see who got on top of it. It either would have been a safety or six. It's six for the hosts. And inexplicably, the Indians, despite being 7 points down at the break, now lead for the first time since the first quarter on a special team score. On to attempt the PAT is Zimmerman. The snap, the hold, the kick splits the uprights. A blocked punt in the end zone gives Hayes the lead. Garden City will get the ball back with 4:35 to go. Now trailing 21-14 on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
There's some reason we're all here. To create an amazing experience for each life we touch. If we look closely, we might just see there's something about you amazing people. These amazing drinks served this amazingly fast. There's just something about Scooter's Coffee.
A special team score for the Indians with 4:35 to go in the ballgame has given Hayes their first lead of the second half. A blocked punt in the end zone of Eddie Rodriguez, followed on by Wyatt Kirkpatrick, one of the leaders of this defense, came into tonight tied across the entire WAC conference in tackles, second in the conference in tackles for loss, scores his first career touchdown. And Hayes have now scored 14 unanswered in the second half to lead it by 7. Calvin here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. What a game that we have had here in this conference opener. Back and forth and gone. Plenty of turnovers in this contest. In a game where Garden City was being pinned back at their own 2-yard line, Ethan Allen records that interception in the end zone, runs it out to the 2. Garden City can't move anywhere, are forced to punt out of their own end zone. And the ensuing punt blocked to give the Indians their first lead. Zimmerman, who made the pay, he strides forward and sends this one way towards the right end zone. But we return by Villalobos back at the 15-yard line, trying to get in the middle of the field. Nowhere to go and taken down at the 17. The Indians special teams making play after play. That's Jace Myers, the sophomore, on the tackle for the Hands team. So now Garden City's going to have to respond. Ethan Gomez, who was 6-for-6 in the first half for 111 yards, one touchdown, no picks. In this second half, has gone 1-for-3 for 13 yards and an interception. As a game that really reminds you of that week one loss against Wichita Heights, where Garden City led by 13 at the break and lost by 1. They'll come out in the flex bone set, one wide receiver to each side, Zunt to the far, sneak to the near. Handoff goes straight up the middle to Ruiz, who's got nowhere to go. Got back to the line of scrimmage, nothing more, nothing less. Braden Bickle on the tackle. They'll say loss of 1 for Ruiz, who in his return game just has not got it going. Does have a pair of touchdowns, one on the ground and one on a 10-yard reception. But in this game, his longest rush has been 10, and that was his 22nd carry of the night. 4 minutes to go here at Lewis Field and Hayes, second down 11 for the Buffaloes at their own 19-yard line. Same formation, one wide receiver to each side, triple option setup. Gomez under center, takes the snap. Pitch on to the near sideline for Sutton, who gets away. Might be looking to throw. Sutton instead takes off. Past the 20-yard line. Cuts in the middle of the field, 25. Now out to the 30. Sutton moving towards the far side at the 40. Emilio Sutton pushed out of bounds at the 44-yard line. Well, very similarly to week one, Sutton had a big play on the ground to spark Garden City's offense. He does the same thing here as he takes this one roughly 30 yards. First carry of the night for Emilio, who had a 10-yard reception in the first half. An end-around play where I believe he was trying to set up and throw to Sneed. Pump fake once, cut along the near sideline into the middle of the field, and got all the way up to the 45-yard line. Gain of 28 for Zunt. Clock now at 3:33 to go in the ballgame. Garden City trails 21-14. First down and 10 for the Buffs to their own 45. Villalobos in motion towards the near sideline. Give it to Ruiz. Big hole past midfield. 45-40. Near sideline 30. One man in pursuit. Ruiz cuts back at the 20. 15. Taken down at the 10. Huge run for Mario Ruiz. His biggest of the night. And Garden City's driving, trying to tie this ball game up. Garden City now in the Lewis Automotive Group red zone. Lewis Automotive, your home of drivers in Southwest Kansas. First time in the red zone, all half for Garden City as they spot Ruiz down at the 12-yard line. Huge carry for Mario. First down and 10 for the Buffaloes in the red zone. One wide receiver to each side. Leisure to the far sideline, sneaks in there. Villalobos goes in motion. Ruiz gets the handoff, spins off of a tackle past the 10-yard line, taken down around the 7. Gain of 4 for Ruiz, who rushed for, we'll say, give or take 33 yards, and now 4 on that last carry. Second down and 7 coming up. They say gain of 3 for Ruiz, that biggest rush of the season for him.
did a great job to read his offensive line. Got a great hold by Ethan McMillan, exact pitch along the left side of the offensive line. 2:19 to go in this ball game. Buffalo's down 7. Fake the pitch to Allen. Gomez under pressure, out of one, throws for the goal line high and incompletes. Did a great job to get away from an on-rushing Indian pass rusher. Threw it too high for Marlon Ruiz, and it's going to bring up 3rd down and 7 at the 9. They set up the pitch to Ethan Allen.
7 yards to go.
Two Indians got into the backfield. Gomez ducked underneath of one. I'm not sure if he was trying to hit Ruiz or throw it away. Regardless, he makes the right play. Clock stops at 2:11 to go. Garden City's given up 14 unanswered here in this second half. They trail 21-14 and are 9 yards away from tying this ball game up. One wide receiver to each side. Sunk to the far, sneaks in there. And before Garden City takes a delay of game, Brian Hill uses the timeout. That's his second of the half. Under 2:15 to go. The clock is still winding here at Lewis Field, but they'll get that checked in a moment. Garden City trails at 21-14 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Trail at 21-14 here at Lewis Field in Hays, but are just 9 yards away from tying this ball game up. Cal Freeman here for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. You're the conference opener for the Buffs, who stand at 2-1 on the season. Hays also at 2-1 on the air, but they are 1-0 in WAC play, trying for a pivotal come-from-behind victory to move to 2-0 in conference play, which would do so much this season with how good that Liberal has been. Garden City takes on Liberal next weekend back at Buffalo Stadium. We invite you to join us at 6:30 this time next Friday, 7 o'clock kickoff for the Buffalo's home conference opener. Some score updates before we get you back to the action here. The out-of-town scoreboard is brought to you by Crazy House, the Boot King of Kansas. Great Bend is on their way to their second win of the season. They lead 55-0 against Wichita Southeast, and Scott City with a 30-0 win over TMP as the Beavers move to 3-1. Clock is reset to 2:09 to go in this ball game. It's a 3rd down and 7 for Garden City at the Hays 9-yard line, trailing 21-14. Ethan Gomez, 1 touchdown, 1 interception in this game. 1 wide receiver to each side, the triple option formation. Gomez to throw, looking, fires far sideline. Allen has a block, 5, end zone, touchdown, Ethan Allen. 9-yard pitching catch from Gomez to Allen. It's Ethan's 4th touchdown in 4 games this season. And the Buffs are an extra point away from tying this game up with 2:04 to go. What a drive from Garden City. The big 28-yard rush by Zunt, a 30-plus-yard run by Ruiz, and Gomez finishes it off with his 6th touchdown pass of the year as he finds Ethan Allen, who scores his 2nd receiving touchdown. Rodriguez on for the PAT, just had his punt blocked. Holder is Zunt, snap, hold, kick, on its way. And with 2:04 to go, this game is tied. An excellent 8-play drive from Garden City, responding to adversity after the locked punt. And we are tied in this conference opener. 2:04 to go, you do not want to change the radio dial. 21-21 between Garden City and Hays here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
The mission of the Casnetti Group is to make your insurance experience convenient, simple, and affordable. They would meet a welcoming staff and people that really care about them and want to, you know, help them with their needs, whatever that might be. What is most satisfying about what I do is our clients. Bottom line, I love just watching our clients grow and get to be part of their life.
What a thriller here in Hays for the Garden City Conference opener. The Buffaloes, after a blocked punt, march down the field and tie this ball game. A 9-yard pitch and catch from Ethan Gomez to Ethan Allen. The second touchdown pass of the night for Gomez, the third score of the game for Garden City. And with just 2 minutes and 4 seconds to play, we are tied between the Buffaloes and Indians. Calvary Rainier for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. This is a game that when I saw it to Brian Hill earlier this week said it's always favored the road team. Last season's game was just as crazy. Garden City, despite trailing 16-0 at the end of one, came from behind and only lost by four at home against the Indians last season. Now Hayes will get the ball back with a chance to win it. Rodriguez from right to left sends this one away. This is going to be returnable. It's caught by Purdy at the 13-yard line. He gives it off to Cano. Cano off to the 20-yard line past the 25, and he's upended by Sunt at the 24, I should say. It was Cano who made the catch initially. So Hayes is going to have to move the ball 76 yards downfield. Now, they almost did that earlier on in this quarter. This is a game that could be so differently based on a couple of plays. From the 2-yard line, Hayes went to the end zone on a pass. A slant was in and out of the hands of the wide receiver, intercepted by Allen in the end zone. He returned the ball out to the 2 when he could have taken the knee for a touchback. Two plays later, Garden City almost takes a safety, and then on a blocked punt, Hayes retakes the lead. First down and 10, they throw the out route, pass caught at the 30-yard line, cuts back into the middle of the field, and upended at the 31-yard line. Jarek Purdy makes the catch, who came in tonight fourth in the WAC in receiving yards, and he'll pick up a solid 7 here on first down. But Allen, after making that game-saving interception, ran it out of the end zone, the punt was blocked, but Allen has now made amends with a game-tying touchdown. Clock to 1:30 to go here in the game. Second and 7 for the Indians. We're looking to throw. Graham, plenty of time. Instead, rifles underneath. Pass caught by Viegra, and he gets pushed out of bounds at the 39-yard line. Indians want a flag. They're not going to get it as Braden Dibble pushed him out of bounds. First down for Hayes. First catch of the night by the running back, who carried for 33 yards in the first half and got a touchdown. They down and out at the 40-yard line. Clock stops, importantly, with 1:24 to go. Hayes have all three timeouts to use. First and 10, two wide receivers to the near side and a pistol. Handoff goes to Viegra, trying to get to the outside, and he'll get one, maybe two. Had Eddie Rodriguez right around the back of him from the moment he got the football, and he gets two on the play. So clock winds to 107. No timeout used by Hayes, interestingly. Second down and 8 at their own 42-yard line. Tie ball game at 21. Graham, pump fakes, looks, throws downfield for Purdy. Too far, incomplete, no flags. Third down and 8 coming up. Bit of an odd play. I don't know if the snap count was right for the wide receivers, because when Purdy took the snap, the only one who moved was Purdy along the near sideline. Pump fake to nobody. Wasn't a whole ton of pass rush for Garden City, as this Hayes team has won the game in the trenches. They've done a great job defensively slowing up the run, and they have given Cooper Graham plenty of time to throw in this game. Third down and 8 on their own 42. Under a minute to go. Graham, bootleg, far sideline, looking, fires in and out of the hands of the receiver and incomplete. Looking for Kano, a little high bounce in and out of his hands and off of his left shoulder. Fourth down coming up. Clock stops with 50 seconds to go in the ball game. 50, excuse me. And Hayes is going to have to punt this one. For Graham, who has done an excellent job punting this game, he's pinned Garden City inside the 10-yard line 3 separate times tonight, including as far back as the 2. Play clock hasn't started yet. And the clock, for whatever reason, is winding. It's down to 47 seconds. Now it stops. So 3 seconds just ran off the clock for no reason. Graham gets the ball and sends this one away towards the far sideline. Nobody's deep for Garden City. They won't return this. It's not a long punt. It'll take a Buffalo's bounce to the 37-yard line. And with 38 seconds to go and one timeout, the Buffaloes will get a chance to drive down the field and win this one. Where does the killer instinct come out in this team? Could it come out right now? The Buffaloes, with just one timeout to use, they have not attempted a field goal all season, so I'm not going to come out and say what field goal range could be for this Buffaloes team. What they do have to do is get the ball down the field and try and avoid overtime here at Lewis Field. What a week 4 game we have had. They'll go with the triple option formation. One wide receiver to the near side is Steve, and the one to the far is Zunt. First and 10 for the Buffs, so they're on 37. Gomez is looking to throw on a 3-step drop. Under pressure, taken down for the sack. goes down at the 27-yard line, clock winding under 30 seconds to go. Neither team's used the timeout. Hayes has all three to use if they wanted to try and get the ball back. They're not going to take him. Clock winds to 20 seconds, and I think Garden City is content to let this one roll out. Hayes isn't going to use a timeout, and it looks like we're going to have overtime here in week four. Clock winds to 5 seconds. No team uses a timeout, and we will need an extra period. 48 minutes cannot decide a winner in this WAC opener for Garden City. The strike trailing by 7 here in this fourth quarter. The 9-yard touchdown reception by Ethan Allen ties the ball game and forces OT. Whole new ball game when we come back. Garden City 21, Hayes 21 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
When was the last time your family had their best day ever? Come to Garden City, Kansas, where you can slide, splash, and play this summer. The all-new Garden Rapids at the big pool, thrills and chills for the whole family. Parrot Cove Indoor Water Park, where there's something for everyone. No matter what the weather, we have you covered. Garden City, Kansas has the coolest spots under the sun. Make a splash.
At Lewis Automotive Group, we take pride in putting together the best team. We have a knowledgeable sales staff to best represent us, and we recruit and train the best technicians available to make sure you are taken care of after the sale. So come see us and join our winning team.
I'm Ochak Baji.
I am Christian Brown.
I'm David McCormick.
Come join the winning Lewis team like I did.
Buy local, buy for less, buy Lewis.
For the first time this season for the Garden City Buffaloes, overtime here in week four, tie ball game at 21 between Garden City and Hayes. Calvary Mayor for KWKR 99.9 The Rock. It's the second overtime game of the season for this Indian squad. They won 20-14 in overtime in week one against Junction City. Now the high school rules here in Kansas, each team will get the ball at the 10-yard line with four downs to score. In week one, Hayes was able to score and they were able to hold Junction City short. As Hayes moved to 1-0, they got a win week two against Great Bend to open up their conference play. If you're just joining us to recap this crazy game, Garden City led 14-7 at the break off of parent touchdowns by Mario Ruiz. Hayes tied the game in the third quarter on a deflected deflected pass for a touchdown that could have been intercepted by Braden Dibble and was caught in the end zone by Braden Bogle. They took the lead after Ethan Allen ran an interception out of his own end zone, was down to the two. Garden City couldn't get the punt off. It was blocked in the end zone and recovered by Hayes for a touchdown, giving them a 21-14 lead. But the Buffaloes marched down the field in 2 minutes and roughly 30 seconds and tied the ball game on a 9-yard touchdown pass by Ethan Gomez to Ethan Allen. And that is where we stand. Right now, the coin toss going on. The four captains of each team at midfield. We do not have referee mics tonight, so we're going to wait on what we see. It looks like Garden City has won the coin toss, I believe, because the referee is currently talking to Garden City's captains. It has been a thriller of the game so far, and now both teams will get the ball. Four downs at the 10-yard line to try and settle this one. So the Buffaloes defense will take the field first. Hayes will get the first opportunity here in overtime. They will go from right to left across your radio dial. Quarterback Carter Graham struggled in the first half, went 2 of 6 for 18 yards. In the second half, a pair of 20-yard completions, including a 24-yard touchdown to Mokel. But his most crucial play in this game, a slant in and out of the hands of his lead wide receiver, Jarek Purdy, intercepted by Ethan Allen in the end zone. The seventh interception thrown by Graham all season. So here we go. Hayes will get the ball first and goal, going towards the left end zone here in overtime. They'll come out in a pistol set. The running back, Zane Viegar, the quarterback, Carter Graham. Two wide receivers to the near side are Mokel and Kano. One wide receiver to the form. First and goal. Snap, handoff up the middle to Viegar, trying to find a hole, not much going. David Holguin on the tackle. No gain on the play.
is tackled by number 50, David Holdren, and number 62, Tony Jimenez.
So second and goal coming up for Viegra, who's over 50 yards on the ground in this game with one touchdown, but a costly fumble in the second quarter, which set up Garden City's second touchdown of the game. Second and goal here for the Indians. Same formation, two wide receivers to the near side, one to the far. Low snap, handoff again to Viegra. Bounces to the outside, inside the five. Ball comes out, picked up by Garden City in the end zone. It's Brandon Dibble who falls on it. And now the Buffaloes will get the ball and just have to go 10 yards to get a win here tonight. What a play for the junior who falls on his first fumble of the season. He's been instrumental for Justin Reich's defense. And now the Buffaloes will get it first and goal from the 10. If they find the end zone, they win. If they can't, we go to double overtime tonight. What a game of ups and downs it has been for Ethan Gomez. 6 for 6 in the first half. His first pass of the second half was intercepted, but he leads the offense down the field and ties the game in the fourth. Now he's got the opportunity to win. Allen goes in motion. Handoff is to Ruiz. Off to the right sideline, chunking for 4, maybe 5. If you're just joining us, it's overtime here in Hayes. The Buffaloes recovering a fumble. On the first possession of overtime, they say 4-yard carry for Ruiz. Second and goal from the 6 coming up.
Second down from the 6.
Ruiz, who exploded for a 33-yard run on that game-tying drive, hadn't gotten one for more than 10 before that. One wide receiver to each side. Sneaks to the nearest up to the far. Triple option setup. Give it to Ruiz. Inside the left side, and he goes down at the 3.
And that goes again, there's
so Ruiz goes for 4 on the first play, 3 on the second play. It'll be 3rd and goal for the Buffs at the 3. Garden City just needs 3 yards to win this game. If Hayes holds them short, we go again in double overtime. Second overtime game of the season for the Indians, the first for Garden City. Gomez gets the play call from Brian Hill along the right side. Charges into the huddle. Third and goal for Garden City at the 3. Triple option set up. Sunk to the far sideline, sneaks to the near. And before Garden City get the play call, Hayes will use their only timeout. We'll keep it here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Garden City is 3 yards away from what is a huge come-from-behind victory in the fourth quarter in their WAC opener. A game that Garden City led 14-7 after coming from behind in the second quarter, a pair of touchdowns from Margo Ruiz. Hayes tied the game in the third quarter. They took the lead in the fourth on a blocked punt. Garden City marched down the field. Ethan Gomez, who has been awesome all night long, gets the completion to Ethan Allen for his fourth touchdown of the season after he had an interception in the end zone earlier this quarter. On the second play of the overtime possession for the Indians, running back Zane Viegra had the ball pop out for the second time in this game. Garden City fell on it in the end zone. Since then, a carry for 3 yards. It is 3rd and goal for Garden City at the 3-yard line of Hayes here in overtime. Ball game tied at 21, a score ending. One wide receiver to the far side is Zunt. Wide receiver to the near is Sneak. Setbacks are Villalobos and Allen. Gomez takes the snap, gives it to Ruiz along the right side. Pushing and not going to get there. And now Garden City sends the kick team out. So 3 carries for Mario Ruiz in the overtime period. And the game lies on the boot of Eddie Rodriguez. Has yet to attempt a field goal all season. Will get his first to send the Buffaloes home winners. 20-yard kick. Zunt will be the holder from the middle of the field. Snap, hold, kick, on its way. This kick is good. Buffaloes win it. Eddie Rodriguez, the game-winning field goal, and Garden City
comes from behind to defeat Hayes. Your final score from Lewis Field after overtime. Garden City 24, Hayes 21. Rodriguez has been influential all night long. Multiple tackles for loss on the defensive end. The leader in tackles all night for Garden City. He steps up for his first field goal attempt of the season and ends it in overtime. And the Buffaloes move to 3-1 on the season and keep pace with Liberal atop the WAC. A gutsy win from Brian Hill's team, who finally finds that killer instinct and comes from behind despite trailing by 7 in the fourth quarter to win it. We'll be right back and break this whole game down on the Robinson Furniture Post Game Show, where we'll hear from Buffalo's head coach Brian Hill. Final score here from Lewis Field after overtime, Garden City 24 and Hayes 21 here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
There's some reason we're all here. To create an amazing experience for each life we touch. If we look closely, we might just see there's something about you amazing people. These amazing drinks served this amazingly fast. There's just something about Scooter's Coffee.
It is going to be a fun bus ride back to Garden City tonight. Your final score here at Lewis Field, here in Hayes, the Garden City Buffaloes 24 and the Hayes Indians 21. After a crazy roller coaster game, the Buffaloes prevail in overtime. And with that, we welcome you into the Robinson Furniture Post Game Show. Robinson Furniture has quality furniture suited to the way you live, as their long history of helping people select furniture is well established and will help you make the right choice. Located at 11th and Fulton in Garden City, that's Robinson Furniture. What a game for this Buffaloes team, who led, then trailed. My voice goes again. They trailed in the fourth quarter. They come back, move down the field, and now get to celebrate
on the home of the Fort Hays State Tigers, as the many Buffaloes fans who made the trip come onto the field and will celebrate with their players. What a win for this Garden City team. What a performance by this offense, who were stacked against them late on in the ball game. They trailed 21-14 after a blocked punt in the end zone resulted in an Indians touchdown that put them ahead with less than 4.5 to play. Garden City marches down the field, an 8-play touchdown drive where Ethan Gomez throws his second touchdown pass of the night to Ethan Allen, whose interception saved this game for Garden City earlier on, who scores his fourth touchdown of the season, his second through the air. Gomez with his second multi-touchdown performance of the year. And the Buffaloes force overtime, and the play of the night made by Braden Dibble, who punched the ball away from running back Zane Viegra, who was filling in for Malik Baugh, recovered by Dibble. And Garden City, 4 plays later, attempts a field goal from 20 yards to win it. Their first field goal attempt all season. And Eddie Rodriguez has been perfect on PATs. It was nothing more than a PAT, but it was a kick to send Garden City to victory here in their opening WAC game of the season. Looking at this game, Garden City definitely played the more clean game. In this contest, they committed less penalties. The biggest key in this game was the turnover battle. Garden City did not turn the ball over until the second half. They committed just one turnover on the day on that interception thrown by Ethan Gomez, which was one of his rare blemishes all night long. But they forced 3 turnovers against Hayes. One in the first half, which sets up the go-ahead touchdown drive. The interception in the end zone, which kept the ball game tied at 14. And finally, in overtime, they forced the fumble, which sets up the offense. They didn't have to do too much. They get the ball at the 10-yard line. They ran it 3 straight times with Mario Ruiz, who got as far as the 3-yard line, which set up Eddie Rodriguez for the game-winning kick. Garden City, now 3-1 on the season, 1-0 in conference play. Huge credit to Ethan Gomez tonight. His last pass of the night, that completion for the touchdown pass. Gomez, if I have it right, finishes with 126 yards, 2 touchdown passes, and an interception. A 3rd straight game for Ethan where he goes over 100 yards through the air. His touchdowns went to Mauro Ruiz, who finishes this game with roughly 60 yards on the ground after he had a 33-yard carry in that fourth quarter, and a touchdown reception. Braden Sneath leads the way for the Buffaloes receiving-wise with 63, and Eddie Rodriguez, who was all over the field defensively. That linebacking trio has been so good all year long for Garden City. Carson Krause, Eddie Rodriguez, and on the other side, in Colton Blankenhorn. Those three came up huge in the second half tonight, as we will hear from Brian Hill momentarily here at Lewis Field, which has now only remained with Buffaloes fans as the Indians fans have made their way out. A really tough loss for Hayes. The second time they've gone to overtime, they got the better of Junction City in week one. They come up short this week. They dropped a 2-2 on the season and 1-1 in conference play. We'll take a short break here on the Robinson Furniture postgame show. When we come back, we will hope to hear from Buffaloes head coach Brian Hill as the Buffaloes win it 24-21 in overtime here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock.
Here.
The mission of the Casnetti Group is to make your insurance experience convenient, simple, and affordable. They would meet a welcoming staff and people that really care about them and want to, you know, help them with their needs, whatever that might be. What is most satisfying about what I do is our clients. Bottom line, I love just watching our clients grow and get to be part of their life.
When was the last time your family had their best day ever? Come to Garden City, Kansas, where you can slide, splash, and play this summer. The all-new Garden Rapids at the Big Pool, thrills and chills for the whole family. Parrot Cove Indoor Water Park, where there's something for everyone. No matter what the weather, we have you covered. Garden City, Kansas has the coolest spots under the sun. Make a splash.
At Lewis Automotive Group, we take pride in putting together the best team. We have a knowledgeable sales staff to best represent us, and we recruit and train the best technicians available to make sure you are taken care of after the sale. So come see us and join our winning team.
I'm Ochak Baji.
I'm Christian Brown.
I'm David McCormick.
Come join the winning Lewis team like I did.
Buy local, buy for less, buy Lewis.
There's some reason we're all here. To create an amazing experience for each life we touch. If we look closely, we might just see there's something about you amazing people. These amazing drinks served this amazingly fast. There's just something about Scooter's Coffee.
Welcome back to Hayes. What an unbelievable win for this Garden City team as they take down the Indians 24-21 after overtime. And with that, we welcome in 14th year head coach Brian Hill here on the Robinson Furniture Postgame Show. Coach, you mentioned earlier this week that for whatever reason, the visiting team in this game has just always had the edge. And tonight, your team, after trailing in the fourth quarter, comes from mind to win. What did it take tonight?
Guts. It took a lot of guts. Just so proud of the football team and the way they played and the coaching staff all week long. I mean, it was by far our best week of preparation. Kids just decided that, that we were going to come out, do the right thing all week long, had tremendous practices, tremendous preparation. And I'm so happy that it came out the way that it did because it proves to our kids that if you prepare and do things the right way, good things happen to you.
In the first half, you guys were awesome at the ball. 6-for-6, Ethan Gomez in the first half with a touchdown. Aired the ball out a couple of times really nicely in the first half. What did you see from Ethan tonight?
I saw a lot of fight. I mean, a guy who has, he's grown up right in front of our eyes, and to play in this type of game on the road, this is his first WAC start, and to put that forth of an effort and to really show a lot of guts, moving in the pocket, finding guys open down the field, just leading his football team like a quarterback's supposed to. I mean, he has grown up a lot in the last 3 weeks.
And the big thing that I pointed out just before you came in, your team wins the turnover battle. You forced 3 turnovers in this game to take away that one interception that Ethan threw in the third quarter. What did it take for the defense to come out and win the turnover battle yet again?
Well, we talk about it all the time about how they're after the ball. And, them having to play a different guy, that's their backup quarterback that is running the football. And, he's not used to normally taking that many shots, and he hasn't played very much, varsity football. We didn't really see him play hardly at all in any of the games that we had. And so, this is his first, taking big hits and things. And, we thought that if we could put our hat on the ball and hit him and things, that we'd have a chance. And what just great guts and just to continue to play there, especially in overtime, to get a fumble like that. All the stuff to the kids. They played their hearts out.
Now let me ask where your mind was at, because throughout last week and start of this week, you were talking about finding this killer instinct for this team. Block punt in the end zone, your team goes down 21-14. You got to drive down the field and score with 4:30 to go. This crowd's rocking. How was your team able to find the momentum to get down the field and tie this ball game?
Well, we talked all week long about there were going to be good things that were going to happen to us, and there were going to be some really bad things that happened to us. That's just what happens in this game. And, how we respond to it and how we play and everything, I think the kids stayed calm. There was no panic in everybody. And then, a senior made a big play. Emilio on the reverse makes a huge play. And I think that play alone, gave our kids the confidence to get out of the hole and make big plays. And it allowed us to continue down to drive down for the tying touchdown.
I mean, how big is this kind of win for you? Because you go back to week one, first game on the road, you have a 13-point lead at half. You get the opportunity to drive down the field and win the game. You come up short, the interception on the last play. You come out tonight, trailing by 7 with under 4.5 to go. You see no fear out of this team. You just said they were all composed. You get down the field and tie the ball game. You make the play in overtime. You kick the game-winning field goal. How much does this show about the growth of this team in week one, week four?
Well, let's think about we lost by 1 point because we couldn't make an extra point. we won tonight because we made an extra point. It counted as three, but it was, you know, no farther than an extra point. And so the execution shows that we've grown in a special team area. And just, again, the hats are off to the kids and to my coaches and just the way that they prepared all week long and put kids in positions and again, just playmakers make plays. I mean, fourth downs, I mean, they made plays. You know, just a lot of guts, and you know, just these are the ones that why we coach, and these are the ones that, you know, make me so proud to be a Buffalo.
Was there ever a doubt that Eddie wasn't going to make that?
Oh, there's always a little doubt, you know. But I was very confident in our execution. That's why, you know, we weren't going to do anything crazy when all we needed was 3 points. We wanted to keep it as close to the middle of the field as we could. You know, and you know, if we scored, great. If not, we'll take, you know, that, because we felt confident. I mean, we you know, now we've made however many extra points in a row, and now a field goal. So just, you know, hey, believe in your kids, right? That's what my job is to believe in my kids, and I did not want to put them in a bad situation and let them go out there and win it.
I believe it's now 18 straight extra points made. Now,
that would be fantastic.
I want to find the biggest piece of wood and just bang on it right now.
Absolutely. Here we go.
There we go. Exactly. That's going to be a fun bus ride back tonight, huh?
Oh, absolutely. I mean, these are the ones that, you know, these are the ones that I think that, you know, when you get out of sports and you get out of things, it's the ride home after a big win with your teammates and things that, you know, sometimes you forget the games and you forget, you know, the practices and things. But these times that you get to kind of yuck it up and talk about all the things that happened during the game for the next couple hours on the way home, I mean, just fantastic. And, you know, again, I appreciate all the people that came up here to Hayes. What an outing what we had. A lot of people making it loud over there. And, you know, again, you know, now we've got to come home and we got to take care of business, because we've got another tough whack opponent next week.
But until then, go home, take that bus ride back, enjoy your weekend. That is Coach Brian Hill. Congratulations on a gutsy Buffalo's win tonight. We'll be right back after 30 seconds and break this whole game down here on the Robinson Furniture Post Game Show here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Welcome back here on the Robinson Furniture Post Game Show. One final time, your final score: Garden City 24, Hayes 21 after overtime. A gutsy performance where Garden City comes out with the win. Your final stats from tonight: Ethan Gomez, 2 passing touchdowns and 1 interception. Mario Ruiz, a pair of touchdowns, 1 on the ground and 1 through the air. And the game-winning field goal by Eddie Rodriguez from 20 yards out to send the Buffs home winners. Your final game numbers are brought to you by Grant County Bank. Garden City moves to 3-1 on the season, 1-0 in WAC play. Hayes drops to 2-2 and 1-1 in conference play. Well, next weekend, the Buffaloes will be back at home in Garden City, as Coach Hill was alluding to. Another tough WAC opponent as the Liberal Redskins come to town trying to protect their unbeaten record. They defeated Don City 21-7 earlier tonight to advance to 4-0 for the first time since the early 2000s. Next week, it'll start all at 5:30 with Buffs Game Day Live with Aaron Elam. 6:30 pregame, 7 o'clock kickoff here on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Be sure to tune in to our postgame coverage here on the Southwest Kansas Sports Wrap-Up. Aaron Elam is waiting by back in Garden City, I'm sure celebrating with a ton of Buffaloes fans out at Barron's. We will sign off for now and send it over to Aaron Elam, who will give you all your scores around Kansas and a look around with some other coaches and broadcasters calling in. Thank you so much for tuning in to this presentation of Garden City Buffaloes football on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Thank you so much to my board operator back in Garden City for Colin Willoff for producing this game. But for now, thank you so much for tuning in. I've been Calford, been saying so long, and thank you for tuning in, whether it was just now, for overtime, for the second half, or for the entire game. We appreciate you for all your listenership on KWKR 99.9 The Rock. Starting off from Hayes.